And, well, I'm gonna miss you guys.
And we good? Why? Yeah. We're gonna see you tomorrow. Yeah.
I'm gonna miss you till tomorrow.
Oh, oh, you're lonely.
I'm, well, my mother's visiting.
Oof. Oh, and, that's why you don't want to go home.
No, no, no. You know what?
No, you get along with your mom.
Yeah, mom's is doing really well. So we had a thing where we were just arguing a lot because she ultimately hates my guts because I'm just an ass. But we're having a good time this time. And then
what are you doing with her?
That's the only thing is that she can't drive. I have to, like, she does. She's doing things.
How long does she stay with you?
She
a month?
A week and a half, and then she went back home because she had to go to an appointment and then come back.
For another week or so?
Yeah. Wow. Which I don't mind.
Do you take her to a play or something? What do you do with her?
Oh, shit, man.
No?
No.
Oh, shit, what do you man. Do? I don't do nothing.
When your parents get older, you go out to eat a lot.
We went out to eat last night.
Yeah, that's what you do.
Had some fish and shit. So, anyway, she's
and talk about gas prices. That was the conversations I had with my old man at the end.
Really?
Talk about gas prices.
And we ate.
And you said you didn't talk to your moms for a year.
Yeah, I'm up to about a year. It's all good.
No problem.
Nope.
Things happen. I haven't talked to my sister in 10.
10?
Damn.
10 years.
You know where she is?
I read over.
Was it worth... was the problem that... Was it worth 10 years of not talking? Yeah. Okay.
It was,
do you share?
Yeah, about my sister?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a simple...
It always starts as a simple thing, right?
Mental illness is...
Ugh.
It affects people.
No
shit. It doesn't just affect
the
those
person.
People.
Thank you. Thank you. And they don't... They want to be treated as an equal.
They're
creating havoc all around them. Like, you don't get a chance to be an equal in this.
After a while, that blood tie thing, you go, this can't be what it's supposed... This loyalty to...
Wow. Is she all right, though?
Yeah, she's fine. She's married and everything. And I just don't... I don't even know how to speak to her. I haven't talked to her in 10 years.
Right? Gets to that point.
It was weird. I don't know how we were the same.
It was just a basic thing that started it?
It was going on for years. Like, she started to delve into strangeness. And,
yeah, but what got you where you said, I can't talk to you anymore?
Where something happened where she was telling me something my mother did. She didn't like my mother for some reason. And she was telling me something my mother did. Like, she goes, she threw me out the house. And I said, and she was so convincing that if I didn't know the real story, I would have believed that.
Yeah.
And I go, she asked you to wash dishes. And she said, you got a choice, wash dishes or leave, which was bullshit. She left. So
she didn't have to leave. It was just what
it was
moms
bullshit.
Do.
Yeah. So she comes back one day 10 years ago, and she's screaming on my mother. And she runs outside and says, let me ask you a question. Do you love Ma? And she said, no.
That was it. That was it for you.
Then who are you?
Who are you?
I don't know you. Fucking who are you? We haven't talked.
I love my mom. I just can't be talking to her right now.
It's fine. It's just, it was just a weird no. It was just a no, like,
wait, there's no.
No.
So,
I gave her 6 times to repeat it.
Here's the question. Does your mom talk to her?
Yes, and I found her. My mother was in deep depression for 8 years.
Because she needed to at least know where she is.
She didn't know
okay.
where her fucking daughter was for like 8 years.
That's gotta be rough.
And on Mother's Day, around 2005, I would say, maybe 2006, I found her. It was weird. My mother was just down. And I somehow found her husband, because he worked at a place, and I found that place, and I asked where. It's weird how they just gave the information. I said, where's this guy at? They gave me the number to the store he worked at, and I found him. I said, and to him, I go, look, here's how bad you look. You're with someone's daughter who hasn't spoken to their mother for fucking close to 10 years. And how does that make you look? He goes, well, she doesn't want you. I said, you grab her by her fucking head mash her face into the fucking phone so that her mother knows she's alive.
Yeah, that's just it. Like,
and I guess he did.
Yeah.
And she called, and then my mother was okay. And I mean.
And they talked every once in a while?
Yeah, damn. That's because it's a mother. And I guess a mother's love, and I always say this, a father's love can never match a mother's love, because a father go, fuck you. I got more sperm where you came from. But like a mother's love is such a burden. My mother just could not. And I always looked at her like, why are you suffering like this? She's an ass.
Did you ever know your father?
Nah. I know who he is.
But growing up, you had no clue, right?
Well, my mother was young. And
yeah, you got a young mom, right?
Well, I'm 40. She's 61. So.
Yeah, that's young.
So she had me very young.
Yeah, no shit.
She had me at 21. 20. And when I look at 21-year-old women...
21, 21.
That's deliciously young. So my mother was deliciously young when she had me. By an old guy.
She had a lot of juice, though,
who was cheating on his wife, yeah. And here's a, what a trooper. This is why I'm mad. And my mother's mad at these Tiger Woods bitches. Because women who did things back in the day, they just had a code. My mother didn't snitch him out. She didn't take him to court and all that. Maybe she should have. But she said, yeah, your father's this guy. And then she goes, yeah, he has a bunch of sons that I didn't know I knew. And she goes, yeah, you know this guy named Big Mo, I call him Big Mo. I go, yeah, I know Big Mo. Well, he's your brother. I go, and so I saw, this is...
And you knew these guys from the neighborhood?
Dude, this is white shit and black shit. White person would have broke down, interfered, but I thought about it like this.
Holy shit.
I said, first of all, they don't know I'm their father. He was still with the person that my mother was with. So I would, if I had said, hey, man, I looked at him like if you was my brother, I'd be like, Anthony. And I looked at him, he's like, what's up? And I go... I don't even like this motherfucker. He's my brother? I don't give a fuck. Fuck it. So I just,
does he look like you?
Fucks no. I'm so glad that nigga had sex with my mother instead of that nigga's mother. I'm glad I'm not his... Them niggas is short
and ugly.
And ugly little monkey motherfuckers. That nigga makes ugly children. It's cause my mother that I'm a handsome motherfucker, 6'4". Oh, these niggas is horrendous.
Horrendous.
So I do know that he exists. Matter of fact, he lived about 10 blocks from us. I'm like, meet him for what? To say hi, daddy? Ah, fuck it.
Is he still alive?
He is.
Well, he got a. Is he young too?
No, he was. My mother was young. I think he's 80.
Damn.
Or some shit. Cause,
that is funny.
My mother was 21. He got himself a little young, some young deliciousness.
Delicious.
Just got a solid 10 minutes out of Patrice as we were trying to say goodbye.
Goddamn, that's funny.
That's
shit.
Wild.
But did I deserve an ass whooping? I used to be an arsonist. I burn shit.
I didn't know this.
Yeah,
they're called bridges.
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah. It continues to this day, Patrice.
No, but I tell you, that one was good.
That was okay, good. Let's analyze it.
So,
don't worry.
Very good.
So we'll back it up with a bomb within 15 seconds.
Because he's greedy.
Yes.
So, and he'll try to tell his story about, well, I was an arsonist.
Okay,
I burned and drowned things. Like, He'll try to say something better than this. Go after my handicap.
Go after my handicap. Diet drinker.
Yeah.
See?
So
see? I want to know about you being an arsonist.
I used to just love watching shit burn.
Well, a lot of us all did when we were growing up.
But I burned, you know.
Did you go in the woods and burn some shit a little bit here and there?
Yeah.
All right, then why was it a problem? Hold on. Why was it a problem?
Why was it a problem?
Yes, because I think a lot of kids go in the woods and burn some shit, and hopefully it's a controlled fire.
The psychology of why I like to see things burn, I don't know. I enjoy burning.
But how bad did it get with you? Like, Aunt and I told our stories over the years.
Here's how it got bad.
We both had a fire in our childhood that got out of hand, but in general, you start little fires.
I burned a young, meaning my mother, a young black woman's kitchen floor.
You and your mom burned it together?
I burned it. And tried to hide it with a rug. That was, I burned, it was plastic floors.
Yeah.
No money to get it, you know, if you fuck up your own house, the landlord ain't come to fix your own burning.
No.
I burned up screens, like the screens, where you light the screens on fire. They didn't burn. What they did was just charred, and then you could just poke your fingers through it. And I did that shit, so I finally burned up the floor in the house.
You didn't have toys?
And my mother, but my mother fucked me up so bad, that beating. But, you know, at the time, I tease her about that beating. But at the time, okay, I deserve that. Because if my mother said, hey, man, you know, fires are bad. And see, fires can kill and like some bullshit. I'd be like, what the fuck is wrong with this ass? She's telling me fires burn? So she beat, what she did was beat fear into me. So I had a healthy fear too. I realized that, what the fuck was I doing? So she had to beat my ass. To put the for practical reasons, not to convince me that fucking fire was wrong. She had to beat me because
because fucking I just did it.
That if you so did it again, but that's what I'm get saying.
So yes, it was a practical fear.
It but, didn't stop you from wanting to burn shit.
So if he puts your face on the stove, would that have been okay too?
Yeah. Yeah. Because somebody else's house would have been on fire.
Yeah.
I would have escalated.
You would have kept going, right?
Yes. Absolutely.
A couple things. When she beat you, did you feel like you could have taken her? But you had to take the beating because psychologically you knew you were fucked if you didn't have
her
in your
life.
And you
know what? The day I realized that half of it was fear was that when 13, and she's called me and I didn't come, and she hit me with a broomstick in front of my friends.
Oh, shit.
And I realized it didn't hurt. And then she realized that it didn't hurt.
That's a big moment.
And then she never hit me again. So after that, every lesson I learned was on the job training, because I didn't have a father that could punch me in the chest. There was no upgrade. It was her arms hitting me with a stick, and I went, "What?"
That's what happened. I looked at it
like, "Why would you do that? Why would you do that in front of my friend? What were you doing? My friends are sitting here."
Oh shit!
And then that was it. But I would never to this day. Like I never. It was never a threatening thing. It was like she realized her arm. It was done. But it got me up to that fucking point. I fucked up a lot after that. But she did what she can, and I believe in ass beatings, because the problem with kids, my girl's kid, okay, she thinks she has a say. She thinks she's a human fucking being, and she's not. She's a thing. She's a fucking thing, and she should shut her fucking mouth, but she always is like, I got a question, though. And then why? But why? Shh, be quiet. Why? Because I fucking said so.
Because I said, and you're not a person.
I was scared of every single adult when I was a kid.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Because I thought they all had permission to punch me in the
face. And they pretty much did.
They did back then. Yeah, but listen, you know what? Back then, you know what? That's fucking ridiculous, because it's not your kids do have
this. Now, here's how why he don't think. He started the whole thing where it's back as a child.
No.
That was his psychological profile.
No.
Right.
And now he just tells his name back
now
then.
He just
back.
Said,
so, okay.
Fuck his
No. Listen. You're saying, you're right. It does start. So you're saying a kid has no say in anything, then that's going to fuck the kid up when they get older and they have no confidence because you didn't let them talk, okay? If you're saying you are a thing and you're not allowed to fucking give an opinion or a feeling, then that kid is going to grow up fucked up.
That kid's going to grow up not shooting up a school.
No,
and your mom probably took
it. Because I said don't shoot up a school.
No, you're saying you're a thing and you don't have
Rich.
A...
Hold on.
You're my property.
No, the difference between you two is I think your mom took it too far.
No.
And that's the problem.
No.
My mom took it too far.
You don't fucking get it. You don't
get it. I do get it, Ross.
No, you don't get it, because when you're saying your girlfriend's daughter has nothing, you can't. Don't shut the fuck up. Don't ask. Don't tell. You're
no
a thing.
No one said shut the fuck
you
up.
You just said you don't have. You're
I'm
a thing.
I'm saying that for fucking an extra bit of seasoning to this fucking adult radio program. But when she starts talking, I tell her, look, you listen up to a point because I'm telling you to, because kids do not have the rationale to listen to you. They don't understand shit. You buy them something because you're supposed to. You do this because you're supposed to. If you go, look, go to sleep now. Why do I have to go to sleep? Because if you're tired... Because I fucking said so!
That's so true.
The fuck is wrong with you,
that's
folks?
That's obvious. No,
that's why
obvious.
You only have girls, too. You got weak sperm, too. You don't got no boy sperm.
You got no
kids. You got
kids.
Little girls and shit. Because I pull out. I like it on the chest.
I pulled out.
I
she
want,
put it
I
back
in. I don't want my son to go through what I went through. As a fucking,
hey, and he's I breaking
want,
the chains.
And exactly. I don't want no daughters.
He just broke the chains.
Because my daughter probably, God will curse me, my daughter have 10 pussies. On a shoulder and neck, and they all work.
All being used at the same fucking time.
Just because I've been so horrible to women and shit.
That's great. Patrice, by the way, getting back to the arsonist thing, I always thought you were a good actor, but I guess not. Arrested Development, you played an arsonist.
Oh, yeah, from the fucking...
See, I remember that fucking show. I love that fucking show, and you were part of it. What'd you burn down? The banana stand?
The banana stand.
Oh, right.
Yep.
Right on. See, Rich, You bring up the early thing,
yeah.
But then, it's not always about
Like,
you're right.
And we all grew up.
Because some people have great childhoods and they become fucked up. They become fucked up.
But we all grew up.
That's exact science. Because great childhoods and no discipline. And you saw Master and Commander with Russell Crowe?
Yeah.
You ever seen that movie? That great scene when he had to talk to this guy because he's trying to be buddies with the fucking crew. And Russell Crowe grabs him and goes, they want a fucking leader. They want a leader. You can't fucking be friends with these mother. You can't be buddy palsy wowsies with your fucking kids because they're abusive and they're naturally abusive. They're not even manipulative. They just go, this punk, he lets me do anything.
No, that's wrong. That's you. That's you. All kids aren't like that. All kids
they
aren't
all,
like
they
that.
They are like that.
Are you pals to your daughters,
they're
Rich?
I'll
tell them, do this, do that, do this.
And they will take advantage of every little thing you
get. No, that's human nature will take advantage.
Until a kid has something to say
that's
worth fucking hearing. I do like to shut the fuck
up. Yeah, right. That's 25 years and above. That's not a kid. Anybody under 25
years. When I thought I was being abused, as you grow up and you realize things, you go, wow, thanks, Mom. Thank you. Mm-hmm. You did me a favor by fucking not letting, because I was smart enough to know what's right and wrong.
Of course.
I just did it. I just did it.
Yeah.
So I had to have some way to not do it.
Fear of the beating.
I like the Patrice mom, too. I finally met her.
Yeah, she's
backstage
cool.
She's a good lady, taping.
Man.
She's all right. Hey, listen, this leads to the video that we want to play Friday.
I'd love to know where you were going to go, Voss.
Yeah. Huh?
I'd love to know where you were going to go.
At the barbecue. You wouldn't get it. You,
let
only
me tell you what Voss
said
to my mother when he first met her. He said, you look like Roz G.
No, that was the first.
Roz is Voss. So my mother looked like this big black girl comedian. You look like Roz G.
That was the first time I met her. That was the last barbecue. That was the last barbecue.
But that's the charm of Voss.
Oh, my God. Yeah. She sort of does. Hey, can we play this video?
Fuck, nigga.
Patrice looks like Roz G.
I was too scared to go with that, but all right. Put a little wig on, Patrice.
Oh, shit.
It's not that.
I think that's
you. Why did I open myself up to that one? Danny's fucked up. Everybody's fucked up on this show. I wouldn't think to just look up Ron G. Danny. That wasn't even my mind
Danny
to get a picture of Ron G.
In 2 seconds.
You can get it up there fast enough.
SUV going through parking lot of a mall. You know, people doing Christmas shopping. There's a lot of people walking around in the parking lots. And this guy comes up on them from behind, and out of his driver's side door, he grabs the fucking pocketbook and gasses it, and these women just fall on the ground.
It's fucking brilliant.
They try to hold on to their purse, but they're fighting an SUV.
It's a black guy.
I don't know.
I hope it's a white guy.
Is it?
I don't know, man.
It's not the regular purse snatch MO.
The audio sucks. We're just going to watch it.
And look at these cars. It's a place where poor people are.
Grabbed a purse from the cart. Oh, she had the purse in the cart. And he just takes off.
So good.
Ah,
man.
That's a good one.
Why do women carry purses?
Ah, they're dummies.
Why don't they have some fucking bitches? Why don't they have bitch wallets?
They have a bitch wallet.
Just put in their skirts. Why do they have a suitcase everywhere they fucking go?
Bitch wallet.
What is wrong with them?
The new bitch wallet coming now to Macy's.
With all their cards and
they
whatever.
Got everything that's valuable in this. You don't have to look anywhere else. You just got to grab their fucking purse.
But we're valuable. Why the fuck do guys have a bunch of shit?
Because we'll put our wallets in our fucking underpants. We don't care. They're not putting their shit in their panties or anything.
We don't care how our ass looks either.
Don't shit they should.
What do they fucking need? They need, in case of emergency, break glass tampon.
They need some makeup.
They don't need fucking makeup.
They need their makeup in there.
You put your lotion on and your lipstick, and that lasts the rest of the fucking day.
They need that shit. They need their makeup in there.
Brush?
Some can get by with like a little bit of makeup. Some need fucking giant cases.
If you were a woman, would you be touching up your makeup all day long?
Like, what does that mean?
Keep their phone in there.
Fucking horseshit.
Go to the ladies' room to put on some more lipstick.
I want
to
look pretty. I trim my mustache and line my head up.
Right.
And I fucking put lotion on my face.
That's the motherfucker. Look at this shit. I love this. Come on, you fuck. It changed back to the news.
Well, that's what they do. They got to tease it for a while.
Oh, are they going to show it? Come on, bitch.
CBS 2's Christine Sloan has the story.
Christine Sloan has the story.
On the surveillance videotape, you see the driver of the blue Hyundai SUV pull up behind the woman in this Clifton parking lot, then drive next to her, grab her bag, throw her.
Oh, man.
Oh, does she hit the pavement?
Why doesn't anyone else laugh when they watch the news?
Oh, why is the fucking...
in the parking lot of this Target over
the weekend.
Police say the same suspect is responsible for 7 other purse snatchings since the beginning of the month. In towns like Bloomfield,
oh, did you see that lucky lady, boy? She was an inch.
Oh, my God. She has no idea.
She's walking across on her phone.
I like how her legs fly up in the air.
And he's just doing it to poor people at Walmart.
Yeah.
Go to fucking the Fox Hills Mall or some shit, man.
Go somewhere real nice, right, where they got some fucking cash in there.
A little Short Hills action.
Go to Short Hills and do that shit. Go to wherever
nice
it is.
Shit.
Yeah, wherever it is. Fucking people with money.
Just when you think you know all the scams, a new one pops up. That's brilliant. It really is brilliant.
Look at this meathead. What? How much money? How much money can that pork chop head bitch have?
And the back plate is covered with plastic. It also has a dent on the front left fender.
Yeah, probably from a shopper.
And parking sticker on a side window.
And you'll see it parked on the side of some place where he fucking unloaded it because he stole it.
To avoid becoming a victim, you should...
Look, she's got her pocketbook.
She's showing how women should carry their pocketbooks.
Carry it so you get dragged under the tires, you
fucking
dummy.
Fucking broads, Jesus.
Look at not laugh at women.
Look at the size of that thing.
Fucking broads.
There's also been an outbreak of purse snatchings in Nassau County. Police are searching for two men connected
to sweet little looking
county. Yeah, she's been around forever.
She's looking haggard, but she's still...
Nah, not really. She's sexy. She's still all right, man. Yeah.
That is fucked up right
here. Hey, ladies, here's how you carry your big, unnecessary purse.
Right. Yeah. Your big, dumb suitcase.
Hey, that meatloaf head girl, right? It's like you're going to Walmart. Why the fuck are you carrying a giant purse
and
children?
Women are built to be robbed. They got high heels on, so they can't move to begin with.
Yeah, they can't get out of the way.
Right. They have all their stuff on their shoulder. I mean,
why?
On their frail little arm.
Right. Why make it so easy?
I have my phone.
That's it.
I have my jewelry and my fucking wallet.
All my shit is in my pockets, and that's it. It's like right there.
And we don't wear heels.
Yeah.
So maybe we can run away from some danger.
And if my chapstick wears off, I just lick my lips. It's over. If my chapstick runs out from the day, I don't have it in a chapstick pocket. Rifling through my fucking giant purse.
Oh, they rifle through that for that chapstick?
We have no concept of freshening up during the day.
Motherfucker.
How does a guy freshen up during the day?
Banned deodorant, which is why it causes cancer. It cuts off all your sweat glands
for the day.
For the entire day. And men's degree? I don't even use that because you soap don't wash it off.
Look at dumb Rich with his fucking
stupid
bitch bag.
It's dumb.
He walks around with that fucking thing.
I don't know why he does that.
Rich is lonely. That's more lonely than anything.
Is that more lonely?
He doesn't have anything. Because look at the way it is. It's
sagging in the middle because it's empty.
He's stupid.
He walks around looking for shit to put in that bag. You know it.
Just to say it's a Louis Vuitton. And
what was this? At a tournament that I wasn't invited to?
It's gambling, Rich.
No, I wasn't. Huh?
It's gambling.
Oh, I don't mind that anymore.
What is this one?
Lifetime member.
Oh, you're gambling again?
No.
That does you nothing, right? Does that do you anything if you pull
that out?
It gets
you discounts at hotels and stuff.
Does it?
Yeah.
A little something, something.
And Jesus. Hey, wait a minute. I'll join.
God damn.
I don't believe in guns, but if I get a discount,
you know, like, do you have any? Whenever I make a reservation online or something, it says, oh, do you have any of this for discount? And I never put it in. I could probably save fucking thousands upon thousands of dollars if I took 1 second to, like, check into something.
Well, if you didn't drink when you were gambling.
No, actually, that works.
He really?
Really?
I'll tell you one thing. He really is a sneaky... He goes from just completely coherent to, like, oh, shit, this nigga's lushing right now. It took about 4 good hours.
Yeah.
And we were just like, oh, okay, every time. And then... You know what happened? You said something mean. Like, you started off nice.
Oh, shit.
And then at the end, like, after the 4 hours, you just said, fuck it. I'm going to say some fucked up shit to somebody. And I go,
yeah, yeah.
And I look, this motherfucker's drunk as shit.
I was hammered.
said, this motherfucker just said some fucked up
dealer,
shit.
I called the dealer a cunt.
Something happened. I said, yeah. Uh-oh. And then it's like...
And then some old bat. I was making a lot... Like, I make a lot of noise at the table, even having a good time and shit and fun. It's like, yeah, yeah, that's how it's done. And then some fucking old bitty, bitchy woman on the other side of the pit, like, was sitting at a table, and she turned and gave me this look, and I just looked at her, I went, what the fuck are you looking at? What the fuck are you... I go, turn your head around, you fucking old bitch. And then, you
which
know,
is
people
why,
get like,
which
oh,
is
boy,
why,
oh,
our,
Anthony's
which is why our friend is so serious, you know, Gabe. So he goes, can I say his name on air? No.
Who? Keith? Yeah.
Keith is very serious about right. his job. I go, Keith, how come you ain't playing? He says, I'm working.
He's working.
I go, all right, well, damn, just play a hand, though. You're so good. And then at the end, after I see Anthony's shenanigans, I understand.
When you're playing blackjack?
Keith has to keep Anthony out of trouble.
Keith keeps me out of trouble, and he pays off my markers.
You know what, Keith, did you ever see Scarface when he's in the restaurant? And Ernie?
Yeah.
Ernie had to talk to the after Anthony's like,
I'm the bad guy.
Fuck you. And then Ernie has to slide a guy 50.
Look at you. I'm the bad guy.
How do you not?
You need me. You need the bad guy.
Look at you, bunch of fucking mummies. Just I'll pay the bill.
I'll take care of you. Don't worry about it.
Why don't you shoot craps? It's the crack of gambling. It's the best, man.
I make money on blackjack.
But you can make more on craps.
Nah, I don't know craps.
You didn't know blackjack until someone taught you.
Craps.
Best odds, craps.
Yeah. Yeah, better than blackjack.
What am I going to do? Well, craps.
It's so much more exciting.
I like blackjack.
I was losing once, and I hit the table. I went, fucking, I threw my hands up, and the waitress had a tray of 100 drinks right behind me. And they went flying in the air, and I just brushed her off like nothing happened. Go get some more fucking drinks. I just lost a lot of fucking
money.
It's
always about 100 drinks, too.
Oh, man.
They're fucking amazing trips.
When you're losing, it's just like, you know, don't give me shit. I don't want to talk to you. Fuck you.
But I should be able to act like an asshole with the action he's throwing down.
That's true.
Why does it matter that should be an asshole casino?
You know they got high roller rooms? They should have an asshole room.
Absolutely.
Where you're allowed to call the dealer a cunt. You're allowed to fucking curse. You could throw shit on the floor. Like, that's what you're buying by fucking going into this high roller. It's the nasty high roller, you know, where you could just go, you fucking piece of shit with these fucking blackjacks you're dealing yourself. Die, motherfucker.
You know what's funny? They get mad when you curse, but yet they don't mind that you drink, lose your house, pick up a hooker after there.
Curse. That's immoral.
Everything is complete evil in a casino, but you're not allowed to curse. Go fuck yourself.
This agent dealer was dealing me shit point, and dealing himself great cards, and I yelled right in the face. I went, no tip for you!
That showed her, I'm sure.
I was getting so obnoxious. That's what I do. Danny?
It reminds me of actually one of my favorite casino stories that Patrice was at. Actually, it was the Hard Rock in Vegas when the Traveling Virus Tour was going on.
Yeah.
And Patrice wanted to sit down and play some three-card poker. So I remember you pointed at the dealer at one point, and you went, ah, and the guy was just like, it's not my money. So Patrice just pointing at the cameras above the table. So I was going, ah!
when we were playing, I think we were playing blackjack at one point, too. And the dealer is dealing out some good cards for the table and busting. And every time the dealer busted, Patrice pointed right in the dealer's face and went, ah! It was so fucking funny and flustered the dealer.
You're a lot of fun to gamble with, Patrice.
But
a lot of fun.
In my short time of hanging and gambling a little bit,
yeah,
something bothers me about gambling.
Yeah.
When I was, it's eventually it gets pathetic. I'm like having a great time, but I don't drink and shit, so I only run off my own battery. I don't have fucking booze, so
booze batteries are great.
After you know, at the slot machine, you know, you sit there and you win a couple of times. You go, oh, I'm gonna keep playing. After a while, you push the button, there's no more fun. And so
at first you're pulling the handle so you can have some fun. It's like, whoa, I'm pulling the handle. And then you just clink, push.
Have you ever
clink, push?
Then it gets really serious and really, really.
I hate
have you ever seen? I saw a guy, I was playing blackjack once, and he was sitting, he was like this. He just lost. He was up. He lost 25,000.
Yeah.
And he was so he was sitting there, and he didn't know me. He goes, "Can you give me $10 for another bet?" What? Right. He just lost 20. He built it to 20, and he lost the whole 25,000.
Yeah.
So I gave him $10. Hurt. Like, really, you're going to get that 25,000 back? It's not going to happen.
With $10. Hey,
with 10, really? It's just he had to make one more bet.
Right. He's always got to make.
Did you
one
read
more.
The book Onan Mahoney?
Hold on. About the $10. What percentage did you negotiate with the guy?
What was the vig on that one?
The vig. Yeah.
I was winning, so I. And another time,
I'm
going to
take 5% of everything you win with my $10.
See blackjack.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. You're fucking with. When you're playing blackjack, you're fucking with assholes that don't know how to play,
yeah.
And they're hitting when they're not supposed to, or they're not hitting when they're supposed to. Craps. The only thing you might have is someone who throws your dice too hard and likes bouncing it all over the place. But you don't have to worry about the motherfucker next to you going, oh, I'm going to hit when the dealer has a four.
You don't sit at those fucking tables.
Well, and how do you know somebody sits down?
You turn around and you tell them, you go, what the fuck are you doing? You don't know how to play? Leave this table. I go, I'm not betting $5 a hand here, motherfucker.
Yeah.
You leave. Or that's I'll pull my bets back. I'll pull my bets back when the when a new Asian lady sits down at the table, you will see me pull my fucking bet back and throw the minimum bet right in the circle just so I can see what the fuck she's going
to
do.
It's the same with Crash. When they're hot, they come over to do the money. That's when they come over and bring chips.
They always bring the chips.
Yeah, when the table's fucking... Because the dude's on a roll. I was playing in Aruba. I'm not bullshitting. When we were... My first wife, we went to Aruba, and I got money all over the fucking table. I'm on fire with the fucking dice. Winning like a... It was fucking insane. And then my wife comes over and touches my arm.
Mush.
Seven fucking out. You know how bad... You know how... And then we got home from Aruba after I took her there, and she goes, I want a divorce. Bitch, you couldn't have told me that a week ago before you touched my arm, okay? Right when we got home from Aruba, I wanted a divorce.
Let me ask you something about the gambling.
Less money you had to give her, though.
When do you get up and go, I'm going to stop right now?
That's the big question.
When the pipe breaks.
I knew that answer. There are differences.
I mean, when do you get up for the evening?
Yeah,
after you win 25 Gs, like, when I'm do up. You just go, there are differences.
I get up when you get chest pains.
I get up when I'm too fucking tired to sit there anymore. That's when I'll get up. Up or down. If I'm up, I'll leave. If I'm down, I'll leave and say, like, I'll try again tomorrow or something like that. But Keith is the guy. Like, I'll sit there and play, and Keith will fucking come by and snatch the fucking chips and go right to the cage, pay off markers, whatever, and I'll keep playing with what he left at the table. Boom, boom, boom. Like, last time we were at Mohegan or Foxwoods. We were at Foxwoods. I woke up the next morning, and I just was, like, fucking hungover and shit. I was like, Keith, what's the damage, man? What'd I lose? And he's like, dude, you won $10,000. I was like, oh, fuck. Because all I remember was yelling, marker! Fucking marker!
Here's the thing.
Marker!
I do a bit on saying I'm not doing that, but this is true. Like, when you go to a casino with, like, your girl or your wife, and this is, you know, you go... You go, hold this money. Don't give it back to me no matter what I tell you. And that's what you're doing with Keith.
An hour later,
give me my fucking money.
No, I don't.
Huh?
I don't do that.
Half the casino does that. Like, you hide money or
no,
you have
no,
your
no,
wife.
No.
But see,
I'll just ask for another
stupid money, so it doesn't matter.
I'll just ask like, for another marker.
I've sold gold necklaces in casinos.
I'm not saying you can't fucking
build
poor gamblers out of their fucking money.
I want Rich to gamble again so bad.
I'm at Foxwoods in 4th of July weekend.
You're getting the itch.
I'm there.
Oh, I shot craps in Seattle.
I'm at the Borgata next week. this weekend.
You're lucky Jimmy's not here.
I didn't.
Did you or did you not? No. All right, get your plugs in. We got to take a break.
A kid.
All right.
Comes in, he tries to work.
Rich head bungler.
Oh, he's an incompetent bungler.
It gives his head is a physical reaction when you see it.
Yeah.
You just look at it and
your
you just
teeth
go,
clench.
he just punch his head shape better.
Eric is fine from the waist down. He gets progressively worse, like starting at the toes. After the ankles on the way up, it's all shit.
If you didn't know E-Rock, you would swear he went to Hair Club for Men.
Yeah, and they nailed each hair in like an inch apart.
he's got a full. He has too much hair, but it looks like a like it was fucking.
His hair is spaced like those triangles with those little golf tees in it. Remember, like one of those little golf tees puzzles.
Yeah. You think there's a lot of space between his? I don't see that.
All Hawaiian punch hair.
I would kill for that much hair.
And his eyes are just set in too far. I don't like how far his eyes go back.
E-Rock, could you come in here for a sec?
His brain is right above his eyes.
Like a Doberman.
Let's point out what's wrong with E-Rock.
Can the anomaly
point
come in?
Out?
E-Rock. Now, what are you saying, Patrice?
His face looks like 8 different comedians. Drew Carey, Bob Hope.
Drew Carey.
He got a Drew Carey's fat faceness. Bob Hope's nose. Howie Mandel's set-in eyebrows.
He says your eyes are too close.
It's just something. I think it's the hair, I think, that's bugging me.
He's tried everything with him, man. I mean, I'll never, knock you. You got a lot of hair, but it's just, I don't know.
You know, we're going way out.
Yeah, it's just, I was thinking cartoon myself. Like, he's just shaped like a cartoon vulture. Like your neck starts under your chest.
It could also be like one of those Roman war helmets with like the fuzz on top. Yep. Yeah. You got that thing going. Or the balls on your nose, whichever one you please.
Were you born bald or something? And they transplanted hair in there?
Nope.
How about you just shave the whole thing?
Would you do that? Pointy nose?
Does he really have a pointy nose?
Are you turn sideways? Are you serious?
He can play records on the Flintstones. Had enough of your nose. I have to fucking rub it on a stone and cut my steak with it. Fucking needle nose, I don't trust you. Fucking stinger. Leave Archie comic book face alone.
And he just kind of has to stand there, huh?
Yeah.
Take
I'm
it.
Just teasing you.
Leave first lesbian face.
Roland, you got anything? You good?
I'm good.
Everyone's good. All right, E-Rock.
We didn't mean it. Just teasing.
We'll end with, we're going to play the whole song.
We're talking about the plight of the white man. Pete from the Bronx. Pete?
Hey, morning, guys.
How are you, sir? Hey,
Listen, try being a Jew. I mean, I got people still blaming me for killing God.
Hey, look, this is very interesting about black people and the Jews, man. I'm really obsessed with comparing your plight to our plight. I really am. And
go ahead.
And let me ask you this, sure. Sir. And you stop me when I'm wrong. Jews moved on pretty well. This is what I'm looking at, because Jews, you moved on pretty well. And
some
also,
Jews,
and
some all, Jews, not the stupid poor Jews like me, but some Jews moved
no,
on.
No, you've moved on from your two plights that, you. I think you have one more plight above us. Because I count slavery as a continuing epic that never stopped.
Well, at least in your work camps, they let you work. In ours, they killed us.
Don't get me wrong now. If I say something wrong, it ain't because I'm trying to be anti-Semite. But,
but
from 1619 to 1865, a lot of stuff was going on, okay?
Yeah,
I would say in that particular time, let's say just the Holocaust, that at least it was quick, and like in the span of 5 years, it was quick. And the thing about the Holocaust, one, it's still a crime. To be a Nazi.
Right.
Still a crime. It was vilified, the Geneva Convention and all that. You had an actual villain. If this was a James Bond movie and you said, I'm going to write a James Bond movie based on the Holocaust, everything is in place. You have the bad guy, you have his henchmen, you have the hero, you have the villains. Everything is. So when I mean that you moved on as a Jew, you are able to move on because you don't have to look at every German like he's a Nazi. It's very specific.
But, I mean, the problem with slavery with black people is that if your kids are born, your kids are slaves. That was really the worst part of slavery. You should say, okay, you're a slave, but your kids, they're free.
Let's go back to Yul Brynner days then.
And when the Jews were building the pyramids, the kids were born. They were free. They were actually walking around the town.
Really? Oh, wait. It was only one generation slavery during the Exodus?
It was a whole different thing. And also, they took care of them. Like, slaves were actually, you know, part of society. So it wasn't like, you know, when the Jews were building the pyramids, it was different. You know, white people kind of learned from that. They learned how to really do slavery big time.
Holy mother of G! Are you saying that that this country said, here's the mistakes that Yul Brynner made, and we're going to fix it this time?
Yeah, I think these scumbags really perfected it. You know, they said, listen, we're going to get these guys over here, and we're going to build an industry. We're going to get all the cotton. That's why the whole North said, whoa. They didn't want to stop slavery because they had a moral problem. They weren't making any money off of it.
Right.
This is delicious.
Yeah.
And I'm glad a Jew's saying it, because now they can just doubly hate you.
It makes true.
I don't know how you, but here's your situation. Jews' stereotype is that they run the world. That's your stereotype, is that you have connived and found a way to rule planet Earth under some evil scheme. And so ultimately, as a people, you were able to move on. Like, that's what I think is, I'm trying to figure out a way to move on. And please, if you say to me, anybody, just love, it starts with you, man. It starts with your heart. Will you shut up, please, with that? It starts with, I'm a cup is half empty guy. So please, I want to go, look, man. And look, it doesn't wear me out. It just is the fact
you do it easily.
That like I say, the OJ verdict, when the fact that you see everybody cheering and everybody sad will tell you that that's not some taught thing.
It's not about.
I didn't
him.
Text every black person to say cheer when he got away, and I didn't text everybody. See, the this is interesting, because I my thing is, I always looked at the Jews during the Moses time. They could be finished because they were freed by God.
Right.
You know, you know, Yul Brynner wanted to kill him. Hey, hold up. Thanks for calling, Pete. Yul Brynner wanted to call him, like to kill him. And he went out to kill him. You saw the movie.
Yeah.
I know all my Bible stuff.
From MGM.
White Moses come in, and he was the whole story.
Right.
The Pharaoh made sure all the firstborn, because it was a prophecy.
Passover.
Firstborn of this and that, and then, you
Lamb's
know,
blood on the wall, all
you
that.
You know, but, and it's still, you still got, all these holidays based on that. You have a system of living based on that, meaning the Ten Commandments are all really kind of, that's our system of living. That's everybody's system of living, is the Ten Commandments. Really, you kind of base, if you're basically good, that's how you're trying
to follow
live.
Follow some of the, at least the
you know, thou shalt not kill, it'd be
steal.
Nice. You know, a lot of dudes, you know, Travis, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. That's not working out for me. I'm playing with you, Travis. So,
but the Jews were able to move on because there was a national, like what we talk about, the de-Dixification of Germany. Like, okay, they removed the swastikas, the eagles, everything. It became nationally, it became not okay to be a Nazi.
Right.
And that's why they're able to.
I don't know. Hey, Stump Brain, is slavery, what are you doing, playing Sudoku?
No, keeping track. I'm posting this on onaradio.com.
Okay, was slavery ever said to be a criminal act or a crime against humanity, slavery in America? Find that out for me.
So
they got you.
I watched Valkyrie. Just streaming.
You watched
on the computer?
It?
Yeah.
Was it good?
On what?
Yeah.
On what?
I thought it was pretty good. On PC. On a computer.
What's the name of it?
Just streaming it from one of those sites.
What's the name of it?
No, what's the name of the site?
yeah, Patrice, tell me that site that you just said.
Movies? I don't, what's the, slash?
Yeah, just the slash. Everyone knows
the middle
means
slash, not the underscore.
Oh,
like,
a dash?
The dash.
Dash.
Dash and slash, very different.
That's what somebody cursed me out about. I told him, like, go fuck yourself, nigga. Don't be
slash
talking
is the
to
sideways
me like an asshole.
Dash is the dash.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Movies. Dash.
Mm.
On. Dash. Demand. arsonist.tv.
All right. Fuck it.
Wow.
How's the quality?
Oh, some of them are phantasmagorical.
Yeah, you got to look. Some of them suck. A couple of them that I was watching some off of some of these sites,
somebody that
you hear someone crunching popcorn in front and people coughing, and then sometimes people are taking their seats so you see like their head in your screen. Like Mystery Science Theater. But then occasionally you get a good copy.
Yeah, it's pretty, let me see. Like they,
Danny's pulling it up.
Yeah, they got, ding. Look at.
What is it? Oh, hey, Mall Cop.
You know, you just go in there and.
But aren't someone going to get in Dutch for that?
Huh?
Isn't that against the law?
OV God?
How can it, I'm not, what the, I don't know if it's against the law. If it's against the law, they got to find that motherfucker first.
OVGuide.com, apparently.
How was Friday the 13th? It seems like you can't really stream on this, so it looks like it would be an illegal download.
No, look. Wait. Turn it back this way.
Look.
You got watch, download?
Watch trailer or download
no,
now?
No, go down to free pad where it says free. Up. Go up. See where it says free. Down.
Scroll.
No, I don't.
Scroll.
I don't see where it says free anything.
Look at. Turn it this way.
Danny just swings around. Go here, motherfucker.
Click the second one.
The second one.
The second blue line. Click the.
Yeah, but that's an external link, though.
No. Click it. And there's something wrong with the site right now, too. By the way.
All
right,
because this is a completely different site now.
Now go to.
Yeah, but this isn't the site anymore.
Fucking Danny, stop. Just stop.
Just,
yeah, just stop.
Oh, look at all the pop-ups coming up.
Oh, this is great now.
Oh, yeah, fuck.
The wood doctor.
The wood doctor.
Click out of
the
it.
The fuck is the wood doctor?
What is the wood doctor?
It isn't even porno. You would think it was.
That's usually a mouth.
Can you put it up here so I can see it so I have to keep telling you to fucking... Jesus, fuck face. I'm trying to help you. Just let me help you. Let me help you help you.
But Patrice, Danny is saying that a lot of pop-ups are showing up.
Fuck Danny.
I'm saying that this is a completely illegal website also.
They got commercials
we're not,
on
we're definitely not doing this.
Huh?
No, that one ain't working.
He's saying it's an illegal website. And that illegal website can't be...
Patrice,
it's not true.
Doesn't
it's
sound not, like this thing is on the up, Patrice.
It is on the up.
Doesn't sound like, yeah, I think Joe's right. I'd like to get the skinny on this.
Yeah. I didn't fucking say www.littlechildren.com. Nigga, it's fucking movies.
That's
on
probably
demand.
A nice one.
Uh-oh.
I wonder what that'll get you. I made that up.
I don't think I've ever typed that one in.
I'll bet you that littlechildren.com is probably a fucking innocent site.
Is it?
Yeah.
What is it?
Wait, close
it.
Danny, close this thing.
Wait,
hang
I just
on,
want
I
to see
go to Little Children.
I want to see what this is.
I guarantee
is.
You it's something cute.
Nope. Fucking Pete Townsend.
Cute and cuddly.
Nah, it's not. Yeah, I guarantee you. Of course it is. Yeah, it's a bunch of links.
It's just being saved.
Okay,
so what?
Click out of a... Okay, go to...
Who got that one?
Go
some
down.
Some creep. I want little children. Oh, Uncle Paul, you did says, not.
I came in on a .com
watch.
Boom.
Go down. to the second... That one. Over to the left. Up.
Okay, these are Google results.
Right there. Yeah, because this site is down for a second. So, but they give you other sites. There's a bunch of these fucking sites. Click that, Danny.
Oh,
Jesus.
It's
that's
a,
the one I went to.
It's
we
a
just got
portal.
All
just click it. No, Danny. The other one. He's going to click the one he wants to. Okay, there you go. Danny. You just do what you want to do.
Patrice, I clicked the one that you wanted, and a whole bunch of pop-ups came up.
Danny, click the one that I fucking just said.
Which one?
The second
that
one.
Fine.
There you go.
Click that. Yes.
Click.
Go down.
And now
don't
it goes
click
there.
Nothing, Danny.
I didn't click nothing
go
the first time.
Go to part one. Click. Where's it?
Down.
Click all out right. of that. Just X that, Danny.
Mm-hmm.
Exit. There you go. Go to down.
Pop-ups keep coming up.
To part
no,
one.
This computer works. I'm not
part
clicking on
one.
Anything.
Part one. Part one.
Yeah, I see it. I'm not clicking
click it.
No. I like my computers to work the right way.
What a fucking shit.
What would happen if you clicked on it?
Probably nothing, but I don't really feel like
probably
being...
nothing, but I don't want to. Fucking homo.
The rapture.
What are you doing at your house? I do, ooh. Stupid. Ooh. I do it at my house. Nothing's wrong.
Yeah. No infection.
For now,
on
that's
your computer.
Why I've been trying to help you. Stop
no virus.
Living a scared life.
So I
stop
should just,
being horrified.
I should just watch illegal movies on my computer, and that'll make my life better.
There's not a fucking ball out there that said, "Yeah, you go, Danny." You embarrassment,
Patrice. I don't want to fuck up the computer.
No,
it works.
Don't make your voice higher like that. You're making a stand. Just be there.
I
just
mad. I didn't call you back.
Ooh,
good one.
Wow.
This is good radio. Good one. Good one. You
oh, so
bitch.
It's better radio to watch a movie on
yes.
the television. Okay.
Ooh. Yes.
That actually is kind of good.
Exactly.
Having you two
exactly.
argue.
Yes.
Guys, I don't like when it gets like this in here.
It's not like anything.
Look, there's a new offer from Windows Internet Explorer.
Sure. Get out of it.
That's good, though. That's helpful.
Yeah, get out of it.
I love offers.
Get out of it.
Just
Patrice just keeps saying, get out of it, get out of it. That's, every time he says that, a new pop-up
Danny,
comes
look
up.
At that new congratulations movie.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. I've won today's contest in New York.
What did you win?
Yeah, click out of it.
Dude, you
click
can get an iPhone.
I got to go. Yeah, dude.
Click or,
you want an iPhone?
Wait, I get to choose, though. It's either an iPhone, a 360, a just Wii, click or a Toys R Us gift card.
Just click the box that makes it the whole screen. You'll get no more pop-ups. There you go. That's what we're watching. The
screening copy.
Wow, nice.
Oh, boy.
That's good. It's a screening copy.
Oh, boy. The screen just shattered. Something's wrong.
Is this Mall Cop?
Yeah.
You actually found the site?
They're going to fine us for $250,000.
Cool. Yeah. Not me.
Looks really good, too.
Not me, Danny.
I like the I like the timer.
They're not going to find me. They're going to find Danny. I don't watch this shit. Danny does.
Do you know there's actually an option to watch this in a lower quality? I had no idea.
That's when the script just comes up and you read it.
I was just going to say.
What about the, what is that little timer for in the middle, Danny?
That's like a pre-production version of, that's before they even, like, color correct things.
Jim, I believe that's called time code.
This is the audition.
That's a simpty.
It's the audition.
Yeah, but you see, here's the problem. Patrice just goes, there's all these sites where you can watch free movies on. This isn't even a movie site, though. This is just Lincoln.
Don't attack me.
I'm not attacking you.
Like, I'm the substitute teacher. You would never talk to Opie like this. You would leave him alone. If he told you to put up your illegal site, you'd just fucking do it without opening your fucking mouth. Now, don't try to get tough with me.
I'm just saying, this isn't even a movie site. Anybody could upload anything to a potentially malicious.
What am I, the lieutenant that sits here and watches the sergeants yell it out?
No.
Fuck you. I'm the fucking boss.
Exactly.
I'm the boss here.
But that's what I'm saying. Danny's voice just got higher. To attack me about, I'm telling you this, I don't give a fuck. I put it on my computer if it's illegal and all this shit, but don't get all like, fuck that with
me. If there was an illegal download, there will be an investigation, but I need you two to stand down.
That's true. Appreciate that. I'm just saying.
Yeah, it's not because it's not like anybody's ever been sued over the internet for watching illegal movies or music.
Oh, literal Jim.
Yeah, let's just broadcast breaking the law.
But if that is the case, just don't do it.
Well, I wasn't going to.
Don't make me kill.
We are investigative reporters.
That's it.
So, we're just investigating. Just like Pete Townsend was just doing investigating.
He sure was.
Yeah,
he happened to spill tapioca on his screen and keyboard a lot.
All right,
fucking
Danny,
creep.
Google this website, childsasshole.com.
But the whole point of this, though, is that this isn't even on a movie. This is not part of any movie site. It's just anybody can upload it to any file sharing website.
No one has a fucking movie site.
So you never know where you're going is my point, though.
Right.
But what do you know anywhere where you're going? What is the way life is.
That's true. Life is very, very meandering.
It's really the journey, not the destination.
How'd you find out all this shit was fucked up? You found it was fucked up because you used to do that. Now you know. Now, you know, you learned the hard way at some point.
Yeah, because a website that I know and trust is something called zshare.net/. You know what I'm saying? Like,
Why do you trust that one?
It's just something I would never go to, and it's something I would never recommend going to.
I'm not taking your recommendations.
That's why we can have a conversation. How fun would this be if I just agreed with you?
You're spiraling out of control. I'm not trusting you. I drink tea and I watch this site.
Mm-hmm.
You don't go to it and you're fucking alcoholic.
That's true.
Why would I listen?
You got to bring up his alcoholism.
I'm not going to fucking listen to a alcoholic with some type of thing where he's holding on to his what's the word I'm looking for?
Thyroid.
Know, yeah. I'm not going to go for it, Danny. I'm not going for it. I'm trying to help you out.
I don't have to wear velour sweatshirts and fucking sparkle jackets and Indiana Jones hats. What's the point?
Oh, Jesus, this is like awful mean of you.
Jeez.
I'm saying you're alcoholic.
I'm just saying you're shitting on me.
And
I don't understand
why
you're shitting on me.
Who cares if Patrice dresses like Gene Gotti? What are you mad at me?
Don't get mad at me. I feel your energy.
Y'all shitting on
me. I want you to talk to me.
A little bit. Little bit.
I'm not shitting on him.
Little bit.
I'll tell you why I'm shitting on him. I'll tell you why I'm shitting on him.
Little bit.
Why?
I'm not even make me a victim.
I'm getting nervous.
I'll tell you why.
If you call it shitting,
now go home and get your fucking sparkle jacket.
I'm very good.
Go get the fucking bedazzler.
Go get your fucking spyware.
You're very good at context.
Context. I'm very good at sniffing out vibes.
Yeah.
Okay. I love Danny, and Danny knows I love him. Mm-hmm. Right. Danny, we always hurt the ones we love. Danny is in deep shit. His soul is in deep shit, and he's attacking me because he knows he can. But he's not. He comes here with his dumb face, listening to everything. He has
because I didn't want to go to a potentially malicious website.
No,
I am now a shithead.
No. It's the way.
And I have a dumb face.
It's the way Danny didn't go to the potentially malicious website.
Yeah.
It was just.
But
it was like fuck that. Danny has a lot of fuck yous.
But you took that personally.
Because it is personal, because he's abusing me.
I don't think it was personal.
Yes.
I think he didn't want to jeopardize
his
computer.
If you said that.
Yeah.
What do you think he would have said?
It would have been
80 people. And It would have been at least Steve or 47 people I've never seen before. A small man, this small man that's around. He would come in and he would hold something up and say, probably not a good idea. Zip, da, beep, beep, beep.
Right.
Cut it out.
Yeah. Because there's
said,
a chain of command.
Fuck that motherfucker. No. And that way.
There's a chain of command.
I'm telling you, it's shit rolls downhill.
That's right.
Yeah.
And I'm not the guy who gets shitted on as the shit rolls downhill. I'm the guy that steps to the side and lets somebody else who wants to get shit on, but I can feel that it's the trickle down theory with Danny. He's gonna get emotional where he can. But if this was another situation, he wouldn't have did that.
I don't know. I think you're giving him credit for having judgment.
I'm just saying.
I think in a weird way, he's saying, you know, I can't believe you'd listen to your boss, but you won't listen to me.
No, I'm not saying that. That was another little smarmy way of doing that. And then when he did that, he was looking at you to just go, right, boss? No, I didn't tell him to do anything against his boss. It was the way you said no to me. You didn't say no, this is a bad idea.
All right, I get it. You didn't get your way. We had a little argument about it.
No. See, more smarmy shit.
That was smarmy.
It's smarmy.
But the other stuff wasn't.
I picked up the smarminess 10 times before you finally said that was smarmy. But he'd been doing that the whole time.
But you've been abusive the whole entire time.
Absolutely not. Nope.
You don't think you've been...
Immediately, play it back. Immediately, I got abusive once Danny started to go.
You don't think that
you... And then he goes, you're just mad. Because I didn't call you back.
Well, that was after you guys were already fully involved in the...
No, it wasn't.
So when is it? When is jokes okay and when is jokes not okay?
It's not. Nope, I'm not going there. I'm not saying that jokes are not okay. I just know you, Danny.
We all love jokes.
Yeah, I just know you.
Where's the playback when we want to scrutinize what Patrice said? You know, you had the playback on me in 10 fucking seconds earlier today.
Because you know why? It will prove...
I don't know.
Danny's
that was kind of no. I think that was a process. That was a whole process that just happened there. Mm-hmm. It wasn't a one line thing like Joe did earlier.
I'll tell you why. I picked it up immediately. It was personal
because we're on
personal. Danny doesn't like me for some reason today.
Patrice, no way. We're on the radio. So if something, we're doing something that is potentially
don't make him a fucking victim either. Because this is Danny's big chance to be the fucking ass that he really wants to be and never gets the chance to. Now you go ahead, Sweetie. That's right. Because I am the opportunity for you to be ass. Just admit it that you've never talked like this ever. You just fucking you get things up. And you
yeah, but I don't think anybody responsible would ask me to stream an illegal movie on the radio.
Anybody
that's
responsible.
All I'm
this is how he switched up.
So and I'm you, sorry. I made
have
a decision.
Have you never been asked to do anything unresponsible, irresponsible on this show?
Of course.
Well, then shut the fuck up. That ends my fucking argument. You just do it.
And you got what you wanted. So why are we still talking about it?
See, there you go. I'm not falling for white verbal tricks.
Ah, the race card.
Keep white out of it.
The race card. I thought we were all just people for a second.
Black people don't have.
You see how mad he's getting just because he couldn't steal something?
You're having one. You're black and you're having this argument. Because that's what's frustrating me is I have to have a white guy's argument. Black guys don't. We don't. You know we don't.
That's true. They just steal and then hit each other.
Someone would have been laying in a puddle of their own blood by now. You're right. You're right. You don't argue like this.
A verbal song and dance when one of us knows we're wrong.
It's who stepped on my platform shoes and where's my gun?
Motherfucker.
I'm recording a diss track.
That part of your afro sucks. But to get to the point is the fact is my point was ended by saying, have you been asked to do something irresponsible? At first, and I'm really good at it because I've been to court before. He goes, you would be smart enough to not to be asked to do.
What was that, a little jab at me? Because I'm white, I've never been to court before.
Not to ask something irresponsible. At first, he says I'm too irresponsible. No one responsible would ask something like that. Have you ever been asked to do something irresponsible on the show? Yes. Ends his argument, and then he reversed it like into something else.
No,
his
the thing is, because there's a protocol on this show, and I understand if Opie was sitting there and said, "Pull that up." Yes, Danny would do that because he would have the wrath of Opie on him if he didn't do that.
Exactly, and I understand.
And the wrath of Opie is a lot worse than the wrath of Patrice
because he doesn't work for me. But
you can't do anything to make his life miserable, but Opie could.
But he didn't place it like that. He said it was irresponsible.
Why should he have to preface the reason or anything?
But he still does. That doesn't mean, right? This is what I mean about the trickle-down theory. That it doesn't. I didn't ask him to do something like he was my employee. I asked him, I said, oh, just throw it up, because that's what Danny does. He gets the thing, throws it up. I wasn't telling him as my boss, but if I was saying to him to do something that was fucked up, he could have told me in a way that would have kept me from fucking saying, instead of me being stupid-ass thief, I could have just been like, hey, man, that shit, it's not good. Oh, my bad. There you go. But that it was about respect. It wasn't about.
I think because
I'm his boss.
I think because we were just kind of rolling on it as it was happening.
That's
so
fair.
It's very hard to.
I just wanted to let him know what he was doing because sometimes we do things and we don't know. You got to be let known.
Well, Danny, do you agree with that? Because you have kind of an incredulous look on your face.
I don't understand why it's I can't believe this became real all of a sudden. It's like a dumb. I just didn't want to. I didn't want to click through and potentially fuck up a computer I use every day. And he's getting on my ass, turning it into a black versus white situation because I just wanted a computer to work.
I'm not going to let Danny
tomorrow
self-destruct. I'm just going to not let it happen.
All right. Wow. We could take phone calls.
Let's go.
Let's go to Tommy in Jersey. Hey, Tommy. What's up, man?
Hey, how you doing?
Welcome aboard, Tom.
What do you got there, my friend?
Patrice, I'm sick of you, man. Everything you say, every point you say...
Race?
...speaking this far-out metaphor where it's like...
It's called analogies. It helps you understand because you're not communicating correctly. What's your point? You're tired of me? Keep going. And exactly. Get it off your chest. And it helps you to understand, doesn't it? It helps you to relate. I try to help people like you understand how to communicate. You're tired of me. I guarantee if I let you keep talking, you'll say tired of me six times.
Go. You'll talk about women and relationships for 20 minutes and make no point.
Go ahead.
You'll talk yourself in circles.
I got to disagree on that one.
You're just a guy who had the opportunity to hate me. Go ahead.
Because Patrice's relationship skills are very good.
Fucking stupid.
And Patrice, I like you.
No, you don't. Don't try to switch it. That's more white tricks. You don't like me.
I wish I knew what all those good
white tricks
were.
Man. It's tricky white shit.
You give white people too much credit, man.
I know.
Yeah, really.
No, he doesn't.
No, I don't.
Not enough credit.
He has an emotion, right? And once he runs out of emotion, this is what girls do. This is why I'm very key to your life.
Calling him a chick.
No man runs on emotion. We run on logic. You're running on emotion, and as your emotions die down, your argument gets weaker, and then you eventually agree with me. Yes.
No.
Just be honest. Look at how soft you're getting now. Look how angry you was when you first called.
But you see what he just did, though?
You're agreeing with this guy?
No, I'm just saying. You just did to Tommy in Jersey what you did to me. Any little thing that became a disagreement, it immediately became a versus white. I didn't do it because I'm white and you're black all of a sudden. And you're giving it to him too. He's just saying that he disagrees with you.
White people are amazing. I'm not saying what his disagreement
just
is.
Just cut your sentence there. White people are amazing.
Exactly.
Went
saying,
to the moon.
I'm saying it's not a white people thing.
It's white tricks, you just said.
White tricks. So easy. Stop trying to make me like a hypocrite.
I'm not. I'm just using your words.
I am. I'm going to tell you why. Because
Because a lot of times white people, what they do, Dad, you don't do it. Norton doesn't do it. But sometimes if I catch you doing white things, which is you have an argument and then you'll place yourself in a position to be a victim. He just did it. He goes, Patrice, this is to calm down old screaming ass nigga. Oh. Hey, I love you as he's telling me I ain't shit. Dude, it's a trick, dude. You just don't know you're doing it. You're too dumb to know that you were raised to do it with your whiteness.
No, I disagree with that completely.
Raised to do what?
All right, well,
see, there we go. He don't even know how to respond to that.
I just want to see.
What?
Let's take somebody else, Matt from Long Island, who has pretty much the same point. But maybe he's not as big an asshole.
All right, fair
Let's see.
Enough.
Matt, what's up, man?
Tired of laying around on the floor all day, are you?
Oh, Jimmy. That's his name.
If I may get a word in with the great Patrice. Patrice, I am a big fan. I do think you're a hysterically...
But there's a... But
that's another white trick, by the way.
More white tricks.
Voodoo
magic. More white tricks.
Buona.
Give that...
You're Puerto Rican.
He's Puerto Rican. Don't trust him.
The bottom line is this. I don't know. I think it came off of Patrice's esteemed weekend at Bananas a couple of miles south of the one in Poughkeepsie, where he had such an esteemed weekend that he came in this morning and stated, actually...
I said my self-esteem. I said my...
lower on the totem pole to the show.
I'll tell you what that means. Just so I'll tell you what it means. I know I said that. What it means. What it means is this. No. What it means is this. Is that on? No. We're not gonna hear you defend fucking Travis, motherfucker. I know what you're getting at. You don't have to keep yapping. What I mean by that is that I'm a personality, and a personality on any fucking show that entertains people is higher on the totem pole than the fucking cameraman, than the fucking editor,
the phone guy,
than the phone fucking guy. You hear me, motherfucker? Yes.
I do.
Exactly. Now enjoy a fucking show with Travis just answering the phone. Shut the fuck up. What the fuck are you talking about?
Thank you, Travis, Matt.
You know what? Without Travis, and I'm not disrespecting Travis.
You should. Because he answered the phone
your
right.
Goofy point.
Talk shit in the ear part.
Lower on the fucking totem pole. And I don't mean that with disrespect. I mean it that I'm a fucking personality on a fucking radio show. All right? Who's more important, Phil Donahue or the fucking guy that holds Phil Donahue's, who tells Phil Donahue what's next?
What if Phil Donahue says, hey, Google image some kitty porn? I'm not going to, what? So because he's Phil Donahue,
see,
I should listen to him?
This is what you did, something else white.
Oh, I'm sorry. Because if it was DeRosa, I wouldn't have used the same argument.
With Phil Donahue's hair. It's very white.
I didn't want to.
You're right. I used a white crime, and I shouldn't have.
That's right. White trick. Patrice is yelling like Christian Bale of cotton.
Danny, what you just did, Danny, is you took it from the movies thing, but you switched it into the child thing, which is, that was unnecessary, what you just did. I felt what you just did. Now, we were talking about the movies on demand thing, the child porn thing, which is, like, that was the joke part, but the movies thing wasn't a joke part. You're taking it, and here's another thing you do that my fucking girl does. You were being very serious, and you tried to play me like I was the one that switched it into seriousness. You got serious, motherfucker. And
you just dwelled on it. It was just a dumb thing.
There you go. But did you get serious, but you tried to put serious on me first?
Well, it works both ways, doesn't it?
Why can't I make it serious?
But
you won't just say yes or no. I promise you ask me a yes or no question, I'll answer yes
what,
or no.
What's the question?
I'd love to know. You tried to make it like I was the one that was serious, and then...
You were serious. Yes.
No.
Yes,
but
you were serious.
You turned it serious first. You played it like I was serious. You were serious first, Danny. Is that true or false?
Yeah, I was serious because reasons are valid.
But why when you put it that you guys, I was the one that caused it to be serious, you played it like I took it there, but you're the one that took it serious.
I'm just saying. I just want a computer to work. And you started giving me voodoo magic.
That was later.
You guys both got serious at the same time.
Oh, I don't know, Joe. Way to be in the middle.
Ride the fence.
I argue a lot.
Exactly.
So let's just
encourage the listeners to, you know, download product keys and software.
Is it my fault?
No, but who's the one that might get in trouble for it?
I don't know.
Not you.
I don't know.
That's the point.
How about Tugboat on 9? Talk to Tugboat.
Wow. Yo, Tugboat, what's up?
Hopefully you're 50 miles off the coast of Florida helping out a couple of them.
TV, I'm Josh. TV.
Hey, listen, actually, I'm all in a load of trash to Laredo. But listen,
well, I'm sitting in a room full of it.
I got to come down on Patrice's side, man. Patrice is the talent. Danny's just got some kind of a head trip going on.
White tricks. White tricks.
Ooh.
Mm. So when Patrice does that, he's just a crazy nigga. I'm just a Connecticut chimpanzee when I'm yelling at.
Holy
but when Danny
shit.
Does it, it's a reason.
You know what?
That's what I'm saying. This is what I mean by the white thing. Is that it's a reason for him to be doing what he's doing.
He just
there's
looked,
no reason
just,
for me.
He looks, Patrice, you look for every little thing to just pry apart and pick apart. It was just a dumb, it was a dumb little movie thing. You caught an attitude with me earlier because I didn't call you back this weekend when you called. You left me a nasty message.
I was joking. That's what I do. Okay, when
you do it all the time, I guess.
But when we're being friendly,
will you shut the
fuck up? Is that what I do?
Is that?
Oh shit!
Yeah, that's right. Go ahead, man. You're right. Go ahead. He's on my side. So let him go.
Danny's hanging out at Anthony's house. He's got his own bedroom there, so Danny thinks he's above his station.
Ooh,
I don't know,
that's right.
You know what, Danny? You're a fucking employee.
He hears
Act
it.
Like an employee.
He hears what
Patrice
I feel. Thank you, Tugboat.
Hey, Tugboat, you fucking retard.
There you go.
You got in your whole body.
Anthony?
Well, I'm just saying, you want me to... He wants me to...
He sleeps on the couch.
No. That gives
can
him...
Can I
give him a lot?
Oh, shit. Patrice, keep rolling, brother. I love you. Even though I am a 63-year-old white man.
Thank you.
Go fuck yourselves.
Oh.
Goodbye.
Tugboat wants me to act like an employee, and I thought that's what I was doing. Sorry, Tugboat.
What's up?
It's your fault.
How is it my fault?
He feels he has a friend in Anthony.
Yeah.
And,
it's like reading the message board. Go ahead.
This is why that guy, look, I'm not taking anybody's side in this.
Of course you're not, Joe. Why would you?
This is why that,
hey, you know, I want to keep right here in the middle and make any waves.
This is why that guy's a fucking moron, because it's easy to sit in his goddamn truck or whatever. And make
why didn't you say it was easy? Those other two that was against me to be
and
a
make
moron.
It, I didn't think they were bright
more
either.
White tricks.
I'm just saying, like just the guy's sitting there.
These white tricks.
The guy's sitting there
I'm
going.
By white tricks.
The guy's sitting there going, "Do your fucking job, Danny." Patrice, if you showed up at that dude's job and said, "Why don't you do this?" He'd tell you to go fuck yourself. That's
but
the truth.
But it's the thing is that this is what's wrong with sound bites and all this stuff. Look, I'm down with Travis, down with Danny. I'm just saying, when they pick up.
Who is Travis, by the way?
Travis
He's a useless
exactly.
piece of shit over there
what
behind the glass.
What bothers me?
That fucking nothing?
Yeah.
What bothers
tell
me
him not to look
just,
me in the eye.
Look, it's context. I know that, look, Danny, you can tell the difference when somebody's yelling at you,
mm-hmm.
right? Or yelling with you, and it's something, or you can feel something else. I'm feeling something else, and a lot of times I want to get down to the absolute truth of what's really going on. So I'll egg a motherfucker to get to this point of anger so some truth can come out. I'm not taking it personal, but it could be something because Danny's not a sharing guy.
Well, let's get... Why don't we hear the
sharing.
Audio? Hold on. Two things. Steve, I would love to get Steve's take because I'm sure Steve has been paying attention. And also...
holy shit.
I actually have been.
Danny's not going to say... He's not going to fucking say to me, like, hey, man, you know... But I would reach out to
Danny.
What
wouldn't
I say
to you, though?
You wouldn't say that something's wrong.
We gotta get why don't we play the audio from the beginning before just so we can see who started what? You got it, Derek? Derek has it.
Are you upset that he said no, or are you upset about the way he said no?
No. It has has nothing to do with anything. It's Danny's energy. It's not that I'm trying to tell him, like, as I'm not coming at him like a boss. I was coming at him like, oh, movies. We're talking about movies. The context was this and that.
Mm.
Danny brought in, you're mad at me because I didn't call, the message I left. I leave those kind of messages for Danny. If I call him, I'll leave some fucked up message. Like, it's like if we had an argument, right?
Yeah.
And then I always leave, hey, sweetie, right? And then, you know, you're a fag. You're always leaving me messages saying, sweetie. Like, what? What's going on? Like, it's going that place. That's because something's going on with Danny inside that is got to get out. It's some evil.
Is something going on?
And it's not nothing personal with me. I know something's wrong with Danny, and he's not going to tell me.
Is something going on?
Something's going on.
What's going on?
He got that look of, what? He's looking. He's, something's wrong. I don't know. I don't know. Look, I don't have
I went to the
Danny
website. It was Paul Blart. It made me mad.
It has nothing to do with this.
Well, Derek, you got the audio, right?
It's something else.
Derek has the
audio. Derek's got the audio.
I honestly don't remember. I wasn't paying attention.
I think you're reading far too much. Yeah. I really just didn't.
I don't think I am.
I didn't want to play a movie from a website I'm unfamiliar with just because you say so. I want a computer.
Well,
I want
because
I gotta,
salsa
I gotta,
says so.
I'm just saying, I gotta use this. I gotta use this machine every day.
Download a movie.
Fuck
the fucking DS, bro.
Yeah, but you were giving dude.
I told you not to go to that site.
Because the thing is, I was giving you shit. But the thing is, if you had a fucking not did it like you didn't want to, I still might have gave you shit, but you would have been happy not doing what you wanted.
I'd hear it. Here it is.
So you were manipulating me with your black tricks.
That's
maybe
what he was doing.
I don't know what black tricks are. Whatever tricks. Black tricks are.
Here's what we'll do. We'll play.
Make money disappear real quick.
We'll play the tape now with hindsight.
Ruining white pussies. Well, caving them in.
Wait. I just heard someone say hindsight.
Just hatred. Never get a chance to really explore Patrice's hatred. That's why I don't want to get fucking MySpace. Oh, you're just a fool. That guy, emotional men sicken me.
Yeah, well, it's split down the middle. We got a tired of hearing Danny's voice guy there.
Who would say that?
Patrice is acting like a teen girl.
Oh, please.
Patrice is uppity.
Uppity.
Uppity. Oh, shit. Oh, so all Patrice was doing was trying to help, and that was sarcasm in there, of course. Patrice just can't let someone finish a point.
Ooh.
And Patrice has no rights in this situation.
Go ahead.
All right, let me hear that America one.
And I don't.
Mike!
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, man.
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me talk into you all day.
Jimmy, it's a person.
No, it's Mike.
It's his name.
Not that Patrice was actually trying to help. Patrice is the help. Patrice just kind of shows up and does a little bit of help and, you know, whatever. Travis actually works there. The other guy actually works there. Forget his name, whatever his name is. Patrice,
you know what's great about, you know what's great about this guy's voice, which is scary? He has, this is the white person I've been looking for. This is the holy grail of white people, is the reasonable sounding racist.
You mean the guy that,
works hard all day and says, no, you can't have a job, but it's not racist. I want to find this guy. This is the guy we can't find.
You seem to have gotten a lot more racial since Obama's been in office, which I don't understand.
Are you
fucking kidding me? Yeah, a little bit.
And you've gotten a lot, what, less?
No, I figured you would get less, but I'd get more.
No, let me tell you something. I'm like the aliens from Independence Day. No peace.
No peace. No,
because I know that guy exists.
You
fucking. I let all other black people that I'll let them be happy about it because I'm not falling for the banana in the tailpipe.
Yeah, I know. I get you.
This is what it is because there's too many of those guys around. Let go home. He is the help. Yuckity yuck 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 yuck. Come on, nigga.
So he made a point, so I'll just smash him because he's a white guy. Make a sense.
No, he just called me a racist. I mean, he called me. He was just saying racist.
You're the only one that brought race up.
No. He said, I'm the help, and it was being racial. But it's amazing. That's what I'm saying.
If that's the way that you interpret it, maybe you're the racist.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Hey, Patrice, that's the way I meant it.
I didn't think that.
Oh, shit.
Wait, listen.
He just said the way he meant it.
Listen, Danny. Could you say that again,
I'm just saying.
Sir, can you say that again?
That's the way that I meant it.
You meant it racial, right?
Well, yeah, it's called, satire.
What? Why are you talking to me?
It's called, satire.
Yeah, it's racial satire, correct, sir?
This guy doesn't sound like every white guy, by the way. He sounds like every imitation black guys do of white guys on stage.
So I was talking to my neighbor the other day, and he was like, hey, Bob, I'm clipping the
like
edges.
He sounds like that little green man that used to pop up on the Flintstones. What the fuck was that guy's name?
The Great Gazoo.
Yeah, you sound like the Great Gazoo, you cunt.
hey, Derek.
Yeah, Derek.
Do you have the audio?
Let's hear how this, with hindsight now, we can listen in, see how this transpired. And see maybe if we could find out what really happened here.
Let's do that.
Let's listen.
Go to part one. Click, where is it?
Down.
Click all out right of that. Just X that, Danny.
Mm-hmm.
Exit. There you go. Go to down.
Pop up,
but here's the thing.
You're being a little. You're being a little. All right, we got to
stop
it now.
Let me explain.
You're being combative.
Let me say something to you, though.
All right,
and,
Mr. Combative.
And make sure that this is not, which is what I am.
Yeah.
But Danny worked with me a few times when we did the XM show.
Sure.
Danny knows that I'm not talking to him like that, like he's a fucking second-class citizen. He knows that.
I never thought you were, but my point at that point in time was that there are pop-ups happening all over the computer, and that's red flag number 8 already. So, at that moment, I do not want to continue this.
Maybe at this point, while we listen to this, let me just say, maybe I owe him this. I'm not savvy with the game of what's popping up, and I just pop up the shit. I just learned that
spyware, the antivirus,
antiviruses are bullshit. Mm. So I'm sitting there going, oh, okay, that's new to me. But I have the antivirus, and I just do anything thinking the antivirus is going to say, hey, man, this site's fucked up. And that's me. So my thing is, at the point, you never said, and we'll keep listening, you never said, you said there's pop-ups and this and that. Maybe my savvy on computers is so low that you didn't expect it to be that low. Meaning this, that I should, when you said it should be popped up, that there's going to be pop-ups, I should have been like, oh, never mind. But I don't give a fuck because pop-ups in my world.
But Danny did, and now in Danny's defense, he did explain why he gives a fuck because he doesn't want a fucked up computer.
He didn't explain that until later.
All right, let's listen. Let's listen.
Go ahead.
We got the tape. Let's just listen. Back to the tape.
Where's it?
Down.
Click on that. Just X that, Danny.
Just click another thing.
Danny. There you go. Go down.
Pop-ups keep coming up.
Part one.
This computer works. I'm not clicking on anything.
Part one.
Yeah, I see it. I'm not clicking it. No. I like my computers to work the right way.
What a fucking shit.
What would happen if you clicked on it?
All right. Hold on. Now we're back live again.
Okay,
now.
Now
he did say.
Yes, just now. Now, there you go. I didn't give a fuck still.
You didn't give a fuck.
But there's still no, like, my savvy on that is still, like, I'm like, just push X.
But he kind of explained why.
Said pop-ups are coming up.
He goes, pop-ups are coming up because I want a computer that works. I don't want fucked up. Should he have to explain to you the theory behind?
Why not? Okay, I'm so fucked up, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why did this continue? Why did we end up seeing some of Maul?
Because you wouldn't let it go.
Because we were being kind to our guest.
Oh, eat ass. Eat dick, motherfucker.
How is it that it's... Patrice, really.
I
have a problem.
Cut that shit off.
I have a problem with you pretending to be so computer illiterate that you have no idea that pop-ups are potential malicious.
So don't judge. Here's what you're opening up. You're opening up the fact that if you don't know something that I think you should know, that I have the right to decide how not intelligent you are on that. I'm not savvy to where I give a fuck about pop-ups because I have
I'm sorry that the host of Web Junk might know something about pop-ups on the internet.
That doesn't make me need to know about pop-ups.
That's a good point.
Web Junk.
He's got a point.
Look who came off the fucking fence.
Oh, my God.
Don't take a stance, Joe.
I'm trying to jump in.
Oh, my God.
You're
crazy.
I got to say this.
I know,
but I do want to say this much. Regardless of either fucking guy, what you think or whatever, I think the simple fact of the matter is,
don't have any shoulders.
Your first
or hair conditioner.
Your hair is dry. Your shoulders a little.
What are you conditioning your hair with? Sand?
First of all, your neck is the same width as your shoulders. Is that what's wrong?
Holy shit!
Go ahead.
I think the bottom line. You know what? Go fuck yourself. I was gonna come to your fucking defense over here.
Of course you was.
Yes.
No, I was just gonna say. I understand that. Like, your first responsibility is to XM or as an employee of XM. So you're saying, I didn't want to do this thing.
Right.
That, you know, whatever.
Yes.
So, okay.
Was that the worst point to make?
No. Carmine's the big ragu hair.
Shit.
Should be sticking your dick in Shirley Feeney.
I can't believe we're so dwelling on this.
I'm super done.
Yeah.
I wasn't even upset, but I think I know Danny a little bit.
Yeah.
Danny is in pain. That's all my point is.
Who isn't? Who the fuck is it?
That's what I'm saying, but it's not my right when I'm in pain.
Yeah.
To come out like what's the word I'm looking for, man? What's the word?
To project.
Project.
But
it's not my point to project on, like, put it this way. Mm-hmm. If Danny's upset about anything,
Right. How is this me being upset about something?
If he's upset about something.
Well, just hypothetically, if
I
you know, are.
I would tell you, you might be a little upset, too, I tell you, because you were late over at CBS, right? That might have annoyed you a little. You might have been annoyed at something, a little bit of something. But I'm saying I'm not the guy that you project on, even if it's not my fault, that you can't trickle down the fucking anger. I don't want you to whatever's bothering you, don't trickle it over to me.
We still have to hear more though, because we don't know exactly what happened.
I think I'm more upset that you think I'm projecting anger onto you. I just didn't want to click a website, Patrice. It's not this whole big grand scheme of things. I just didn't want to click
you're
on something.
You're in pain. You talk to me later.
Let's hear more.
I don't want to have an intervention on the radio. Talk, call me. You got my number.
I will hear a little more.
I want to hear a little more.
Such a fucking
douche. So far, Danny has been good.
He is such a fucking douche.
See what I'm saying? Joe's against me too, just like these guys.
Don't act like for a minute that you don't do that when you're in a pissy mood.
No.
I've seen you corner a woman backstage in a show and take her entire fucking life apart into rubble because you didn't like what happened on stage.
No, that's not true.
I've seen you do
that. No, you haven't. No, you haven't.
Yes, I have. Listen, I've seen it.
When you're opening for me in San Francisco, we're going to talk. We're not going
to
do this.
Are you opening to Patrice?
Yeah, he's my opener in
San Francisco. Let's not talk about it right now.
He's my opener in San Francisco. Yeah.
What did you make that face for?
What? Why can't you open for me?
No, he made like a disgusted face.
Why? Leave him alone.
That he's flying cross country to the middle? I got no problem with that.
No, I might not do it.
Nothing wrong with that.
I'm here to say that I love Danny, Anthony.
Yeah, I know. I get that.
I'm just saying, as a friend, I don't want him to be in this kind of pain. And he hangs out a lot with you, and I think you should talk with him and see what's going on. Mm-hmm.
Counsel him.
Just say no to one beer and say, come here, Danny.
What?
No.
So what? There's going to be a difference between 14 and 15 beers?
That's what I'm saying. One beer. That's 15 beer. That's what I'm saying. Just chill out for a second. And listen, put in a good movie. Yeah. Everybody loves movies here.
Sure, they do.
And put in a good movie and just say, hey, man, what's going on, Danny?
I'm not I'm not disagreeing with you.
I never do
Patrice.
That with my family.
You don't even do that
with anybody. Fuck that. Let's suck your pain in, put it in deep, and leave it
but
there.
But see, I'm not disagreeing. I'm not disagreeing with you in any way when you say that, because... But my issue here is not whether or not I have things in my life. My issue is that I just didn't want to click onto a website, and there's no correlation between that.
Mm. But if you didn't want to
there's
do
no,
that...
There's nothing I was projecting onto
you. This is how I... See, I relate where I try to go. Logic is... I love logic. Just saying something, you go, hey, man, if I click this site, this network could be infected with something if I click this site. I'm not going to click it. That's why would you think I would not be reasonable to understand?
Well,
that?
I thought you said it 45 times.
You said I'm pop-ups in my world.
No, but then he said I don't want my computer fucked up like by clicking on it. He did kind of.
I don't know.
Is there more audio?
Okay, already at the end of the day, don't click it on. Why'd you click it?
Because you yelled at me. You're a big bully.
More audio. We got audio.
You see what I'm saying?
You bullied me into doing it.
Bullied you into doing it?
Yes.
Did you just victimize yourself, bitch?
Yeah. You're a big bully.
That's just horrid. That's horrid, man.
Hold on. We got audio. Let's hear we can hear what happened.
All right.
Fair enough.
Part one.
Yeah, I see it. I'm not clicking it. No. I like my computers to work the right way.
What a fucking shit.
What would happen if you clicked on it?
Probably nothing, but I don't really feel like
probably nothing, but I don't want to. Wait. Rewind that shit.
What?
Rewind that little part.
No, that's
going
to make you look bad if you rewind it. You don't want to rewind that part. Well,
yes.
The probably nothing.
I'll say that he's saying that the odds are they're not always bad, but when they are, they're a nightmare.
If I'm paying attention to that, see, but I don't know that. What's going to happen?
Why are you holding me responsible? Because you don't know.
I asked. What's going to happen? Probably nothing. I'm very childlike when it comes to computers.
Mm.
What's going to happen? Probably nothing. So if nothing's probably going to happen, click. Come on now. Don't make this one of these fucking things from the 60s. Don't make this a fucking 60s.
I don't have a German Shepherd or a fire
hose. Don't make this the O.J. trial. Don't make this the civil case.
Hey, look where we got to.
Do I make sense when I ask that?
Well,
did that make sense, trial?
When I heard that, the first thing I thought was, well, he did just say probably nothing. But then I heard Patrice get all like,
but probably nothing. When I heard that, I understood that
with
understood.
Yeah, spyware and stuff like that. The odds are it's fine, but when it's not, it's not. It's a real problem.
Let me ask you, if you
am
want to talk,
am I not saying that I'm not computer
right
savvy to that level? I'm actually saying that, and I asked you in this tirade, what's going to happen? I really did, which was your opportunity to go
to start explaining to you like illegal operations and kernel functions.
Already, but kernel. You would rather.
Well, you're seeing with the registry, system registry values.
You would rather have a 45-minute.
I'd like to hear that explanation.
Argument than to explain it to me for 5 minutes.
Danny, tell us about safe mode.
Yes,
Joe.
Yes.
Sometimes it's a driver thing.
I don't know how to get the safe mode. Don't know.
You get the safe mode by not clicking on malicious websites and links. That's how. That's how computers be in safe mode.
I mean, sarcasm is going to fix this all. It's going to fix your inside, Dan.
Oh, wow.
No, but I'm saying,
that was
what
sarcasm.
I'm saying is,
that's can you, kind of funny.
Let's say,
sarcasm is.
Let's say.
Thank you.
I have a 25% chance of getting my computer infected. That's a pretty big chance of infection, right? But is it still probably nothing? Is the 75% still
Danny,
probably
we're,
nothing?
We're going in circles. I said.
You're going in circles.
I don't know. Yeah.
I just don't want to click on a fucking on a bad
what
website.
You still did. In the midst of all of that, and I asked you, so what you're saying
because
is...
Because you're yelling at me, I said, well, I like control. Patrice, he's a nice guy, I'll do this for him because
you'll
he's not a nice
guy. You'll destroy the computer for me? That's what you said to yourself?
Yes.
Put it on me. Go.
Let's hear more, Derek. Let's hear more.
Should we hear
more?
I just wanted to hear the part where I said what's going to happen. He said probably
But hold on, there might be a further explanation after that.
Okay, just a little. Just a little more.
Can we start with that, though?
Yeah.
I like my computers to work the right way.
What a fucking sissy.
What would happen if you clicked on it?
Probably nothing, but I don't really feel like
probably
being...
Probably nothing, but I don't want to. Fucking homo.
And you the asked that.
What are you doing at your house? I do, stupid. Ooh. I do it at my house. Nothing's wrong.
Yeah, no infection
for now.
That's why
computer.
I've been trying to help you. Stop.
No virus.
No infection.
So I should
stop
just
being horrified.
I should just watch illegal movies on my computer, and that'll make my life
and it
better.
Wasn't... Thank you. Stop it right there. And here's the whole thing.
Okay, counselor.
It was not about the malware.
Mm-hmm.
It was about the illegal.
Something is illegal.
Yes, it was
Black
the fear
Hanger.
Of illegal. So actually, it was you not wanting to get involved.
Do you
in
just
something.
Want to say that you just want to win and we could take a break and just do commercials
this
and stuff?
This is what I like.
All right.
I like, I'm so done with this because he feels.
Because, you know, one argument gets blown
there
away.
No.
You fucking totally lost the argument and now you got to find something else
there
to fucking
no
come back from.
This.
You have to fucking argue again.
You know what kicked that? You know what really started that argument? When you said do it at home on your computer and somebody went, ooh.
Somebody
that made him defensive and that was.
Jimmy. I was fucking
Jimmy
was
taunting.
Did you hear the ooh?
Yeah.
Jimmy was ooh. Taunting both of them.
That's
can
really...
you go back a little bit? I must have oohed 30 times. Jimmy's job is just to taunt.
That's
until
really what
fucking
this whole
combustion happens.
And you really, and Anthony, you really, truly. We're protecting your little fucking buddy that sleeps at your house. I felt you.
No, divided conquer bullshit. No, it's divided.
Can we play that ooh part again?
I was just saying.
You was looking out for him.
I completely understand malware. So to me,
and the viability of sites that host this kind of content.
Yes,
that's
yes,
the
yes,
fucking
yes.
thing.
Let's hear that again because I forgot that I oohed a whole bunch.
Let's
of
hear
times.
It for Jimmy's
Let's
ooh.
Hear that ooh, which is the equivalent of the spider scene in Goodfellas. That's how fucking
yes.
button pushing it is.
Oh, you gonna take this?
Yes. I did a bunch of them. I forgot.
Yeah, let's hear.
Fucking homo.
The rapture.
What are you doing at your house? I do.
Ooh.
Stupid.
Ooh.
I do it.
Oh,
wait, let it play for a couple seconds because I think there's more of those.
And I would never
fucking
call Danny
homo.
A homo.
The rapture.
Do
like
at your house. I do, ooh. Stupid. Ooh. I do it at my house. Nothing's wrong.
Yeah, no infection.
For now,
that's why
computer.
I've been trying to help you. Stop
no virus.
Living a scared life.
So I should
stop
just
being horrified.
I should just watch illegal movies on my computer, and that'll make my life better.
There's not a fucking ball out there that said, "Yeah, you go, Danny." You embarrassment,
Patrice. I don't want to fuck up the computer. It works.
Don't make your voice higher like that. You're making a stand. Just be there.
I just
be
mad. I didn't
you
call
are.
You back.
Ooh.
There you go. There you go.
So, wait. I'm keeping notes here, by the way. Listen to me. All I wanted to do was to not go to a malicious website, and I've been called by Patrice a homo, a scared little boy. Yes. He's tried some kind of division.
Yes.
You called me an embarrassment, and you imply that I immediately threw up a defense mechanism.
Yes.
All I wanted to do was have a computer to continue functioning the way it was working.
Why didn't you do that? You tell me again. Why? You know what? I'm going to stop talking.
Because listen to you.
Because once you tell me, Patrice, you ruined my mind, and I did it because you just got to me, I'll just shut up.
All right. Sounds reasonable.
I just wanted to make the sound stop
happening. Patrice
happen.
Sounds like a reasonable man.
Just...
Danny, I'd rather have called you all those things if I didn't love you.
I'd rather kill the fighting about whether or not we're going to click on it. Mm-hmm. That's to me was more important. It was just like, you know what? I don't care. Whatever. If he just wants me to click it, I'll click it. Fine. Forget it.
That's reasonable.
Look, I think both of you are getting your fucking.
What, Joe?
Oh God, Joe.
He's losing his mind over.
I think both of you.
Stupidest thing.
Joe, take your hips and your chest out of your pocket.
I think he was trying to stand his fucking ground for XM, and he didn't want to do something that was going to fuck up his job and get him
in
trouble.
That was for XM?
And I think, listen.
That was for my computer. I use this every day.
For the computer, I mean. I'm saying for
the computer. I need it to work. Patrice, I have my personal email open on this computer all the time.
Okay.
You know? Well, I use it for, look, it's my priority.
I got to say.
All right, Benny. All right.
So maybe you understand why I don't want to click through to your fucking no-name.
I understand it now.
Dot fucking TV website.
I understand it now.
Okay, look, you two fucking lunatics.
Jesus.
You're both insane.
No, I'm not.
Grudges.
He's insane. No. It's just like I'm not going to let him fucking talk all this insanity to me.
I'm
like
insane?
This.
Of course.
It's just me that's insane?
No. You're both fucking crazy on this issue.
I'll take that. As long as there's full credit for
you
everywhere.
Guys can, like, I would fucking be exhausted if I battled it out with somebody over something so inane as this.
That's why I can't let him win this, because it's so fucking dumb.
So
I'm not losing
your pot invested.
I didn't know we were fighting.
I'm not losing. I didn't want to click on a pop-up argument.
The only winning move is not to play.
Yes.
And I wasn't playing. I just was talking. Now all of a sudden Danny wants to beat me at something. Do you understand?
You get out.
Do you see?
White tricks.
Just drop. You gotta drop. White tricks.
All right, here's what we're gonna do. We are gonna take a fucking break.
Ooh.
Then when we come back, I want to get into a real discussion about Patrice wanting another girlfriend.
Why?
Because that's a good discussion.
All right, that's not crazy. Old crazy.
No, that's good shit.
Old nutty Negro.
No.
There goes again.
No.
I don't understand why you take whiteness. And you're a fucking Egyptian.
You sure
are. That's what bugs me about you.
I'm only half Arab.
I didn't know that.
You have to go. Look at my fucking skin. I'm fucking white.
A goddamn Egyptian. That's what bugs me about
you. I'm white. I'm half Arab. I'm half Arab, but you go
what's the other half?
Muhammad Atta was white.
Who the fuck is that?
Exactly. He's
exactly.
A guy.
How do you not know?
Flew a plane into a building. Fucking dick.
Yeah, you want to be a surgeon in Egypt, don't you? We all know who the fucking Al Qaeda number two is. Azawahari. Don't act like you don't know.
White.
He is pretty white though for an Arab.
He's an Arab.
Sure he is. He comes here.
What's
and he's silly.
Albino.
You look Arab.
Exactly. Yeah, I know.
Anthony looks. You look really Sicilian.
Half Arab, half dove.
Anthony's an eggplant. You're a dirty terrorist.
What are you, Egyptian or what?
Italian. Yeah.
There's nothing white about it.
You're black.
You're hairy.
Danny shits and falls into a hair white.
Fucking Danny's got to start shit all the time. Calling him fucking hairy.
You're more attached to my point of view.
Why do I always got
to
bring race into this?
Yeah. I'm not white. And let this be known for the fucking record and how you operate, okay?
What?
This is how you operate. I'm not white until you want to call me during John McCain giving a speech and go, you know something? Y'all crackers ain't shit. And you want me to take the fucking weight of the white.
No one, I was going in order of white to the next. I would end up calling one of my light-skinned black friends if none of my white friends answered.
Yeah.
And whenever I've there talked to you about...
things going on between light-skinned black people and dark
skin. That McCain speech was fantastic. Why? He was very gracious.
We've had long...
Holy shit.
We've had long conversations.
What is going on? This is starting to make me feel like I'm not a nice guy.
You're not a nice guy.
It's terrible.
You're not a nice guy.
You're having a midlife meltdown.
The things I've seen you do to 22-year-old women's minds.
Oh, man. It's not true.
Look.
All right.
I got to fit a couple of goddamn breaks in. So we'll take a break. We'll come back and fix everything. Hunky dory. Hope you didn't have to.
Why's it got
to
be hunky dory? And I don't think fat people should.
Fat people
I'm
live?
Serious. I don't
there
think
is a
fat people should.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's a placeholder.
Okay.
But it's called. They do have fat couple like hookups. You know.
Yeah, what about fatfucks.com? Let's see what comes up.
Something will come up. As a
yeah.
comes up.
A porn site, right?
It just says fat fucks, fat porn, fat sex. Sorry.
Do they have tubby cunt?
Oh, do they have tubbycunt.com?
It's this whole no gang. Matter no matter what you have.
Is that tubby damn. Cunt or is that fat fuck?
Oh, gee, look at this.
Let me see. Can I see if I get into this? I don't know if I like fat chicks. It's not really fat.
You would go. You would definitely go there.
I've been with fat. Dude, yeah. I was with some big girls.
Really?
I was
like
with a girl. I was with a black girl in Huntsville, Texas. That I had to hold her tit with two hands.
Yeah.
Just a fucking enormous tit.
Big tit.
Big. Oh, I got like on top fatties, of her, like and it was like being on an upside down canoe. Both of my knees didn't hit the bed.
the funniest fat shit. Girl story I ever had. It was this girl I used to, you know, we back in the day we was real disrespectful. I mean, you just call the girls where you met them or where they lived,
like
and
Canal
I,
Street.
And I call her the fat girl from the Wiz. She used to work at the Wiz.
Remember was she the Wiz? In your phone like that?
The fat girl from the Wiz, because I had just got back from
Dude,
Australia.
I remember the fat girl from the Wiz. From That's the Wiz. So fucked up, I remember.
So,
I remember the fat girl from the Wiz.
And
she flipped out, right?
Dude, I she was a soldier. And I met her when I first moved to Jersey City. I first remember. In like 99. And we talked, and I brought her home, and we was talking about the pocket rocket. Because I bought this girl that I met in Australia a pocket rocket and was going to send it to her. And the fat girl from The Wiz was like, I use that. That's the G4. They go, the G4. And I go, yeah. We were talking. We was going about the pocket rocket. We end up talking. She comes over to the house. Mm. We fucking go at it, right? So I used to have a roommate. And I mean, I learned a lot of my debauchery from this girl, I have to say.
The fat girl.
Yeah, yeah, a lot of the horrible shit that I learned to do to
from
girls.
That girl?
It's just because she would lay there and let it happen. I just would do. Yeah. I'm not proud of it because I wouldn't want to do that to my daughter, but
wow.
I would just do some terrible things to her and she just enjoyed it.
Is that
it.
The one that ate your ass?
She did everything, dude.
Really?
Oh, she just used to call and go, can you do that fist thing you do?
Oh, that was the
shit.
Worst thing you've ever shown
thing?
Me.
Huh?
You had a fist thing that you did?
Just, no. I fucking hate
really?
That.
Just get in there and dig around.
Poof.
Yeah.
You showed me a picture of that
like
once?
Like you're punching a fucking...
So,
like
wait,
punching
a,
he showed
like
me a picture
of that,
and he showed me the picture as he's pulling it back out. So, like, some of the inside was, like, outside
pink
on
socking.
His... Oh, but it was a vagina. Looked like he punched a fucking plasma wall.
She comes over the house. We have a mission. So I try to sneak her out the house. I'm like, let's go. So we're sneaking down the spiral staircase. And my roommate is down on the phone. He's on the phone. He's like, yeah, how you doing, man? And then he looks up, and he sees me and her leaving. And he looks up. He goes, hey, how you guys doing? And he's talking on the phone. I walk downstairs. I walk back upstairs. He's on the floor laughing. He's laughing. When he took the phone off his head and went, hey, how you guys doing? My stomach, I said, this motherfucker.
You
I walked
you.
Back upstairs. He was in tears crying.
Patrice, did you think he was going to let you slide at all when you're walking down?
No.
Because, you just knew,
because
right?
he yeah. said, how you guys doing?
You
and I was coming down the stairs, nigga, like, dude.
Dude, the coast is clear.
Patrice, Jennifer Hudson.
What about her?
I want to have sex with her.
Who, you?
Is yeah. she delicious now?
Jennifer Hudson?
Yeah, after she lost weight. But then Ann had to fucking ruin it for me and say the skin's probably a little
I would
loose.
Think she's probably got
Good
a lot
to you, man.
Lot of
fat
skin.
Or skinny, she's a very...
She lost about
she's
60.
She's a very average...
You think she's average? Man.
dude, she's.
I don't know what it is.
Nobody blacks talking about fucking Jennifer Hudson, and that's the truth.
Why?
Because she's too mainstream? Why?
She's just.
That was so dismissive.
She's just.
Nobody's talking about it, and that's the truth. End of story.
Like, you mentioned a black girl, it's just shocking you would say that. That's just.
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
Really?
Yeah, I like that. I like the Jennifer Hudson.
I don't like how she used to be fat, now she's skinny, and she has, like, I've always been in shape attitude. It's like, you should have more of a personality. You should be like, well, you know, I'm just happy. Hopefully I can keep it up. She's standing there now in those weight loss things. Yeah, like, she used to, she's always looked good.
This is how I've always been, man.
You know how you guys cursed me out for Janet from Three's Company one day?
Yeah.
Saying that she was one of my white girl.
I just did the same thing to you?
Yeah, but there's nobody black to go, motherfucker. So, but I will say I put somebody to take the place of her.
Okay.
This goes back to when we asked you about a white girl.
It was
girl
Adrienne Barbeau.
Adrienne Barbeau.
Hot or sexy. Right.
It was Pam Smart. And I said Janet from Three's Company because she had a really juicy ass.
Uh-huh.
Same qualifications as him saying nobody, everybody black there. You say, Jennifer Hudson. You make them literally sick right now.
I just made some black people
uncomfortable. And they probably don't listen to the show no more right now.
That's it.
Because you fucking, that's
fair
your
representation.
But, you know what? I'll replace it with Jennifer Tilly.
Oh, that's a long fucking leap. Yeah, fucking.
Yeah. You upgraded big time there.
Janet from Three's Company to Jennifer Tilly. How do you guys know these names? Jennifer
that
Tilly
was a big
in
upgrade.
Our prime.
You know Jennifer Tilly.
I thought Jennifer Hudson was Goldie Hawn's daughter. That
no,
one.
Kate Hudson.
Kate Hudson.
Okay.
But this girl. Well, that's what she looks like now. Jesus.
Yeah, she looks terrible now.
Look at that. I think that looks delicious now,
oh,
man.
Shit.
Even with that gut thing around the pussy area. I think
the gut thing around the pussy area.
Whatever that thing is. Jennifer Tilly is fucking
you
hot.
You do enjoy a sloppy broad.
I like pigs, man.
Yeah, look at her big ass.
You know, I wouldn't want to date her and walk around with her.
You like that right there?
Is that Jennifer Tilly?
Yeah, it's bending over.
You fucking hot.
Current
can you not
day
like
Jennifer
that?
Tilly bending over, by the way.
That she's hot, them juicy, soggy tits. That dumb voice.
Something
come on, man.
In the African DNA that just says,
probably slavery.
Show me a big ass.
Well, no, Africans don't like big bitches, too, though. Africans like them big. But Jennifer Tilly's hot to me, man.
Well, she used to be.
She's hot now to me.
Yeah, back in the day when she
used to be.
But I can't see
Patrice
now.
Likes them when they slow down.
I
like them when they
catch up to them.
I like to help their self-esteem.
Come on, Jennifer. It's over. Come on, let's
Patrice
go.
Patrice is standing at
We're
that
going
wall.
Home.
Patrice is standing at the wall to pick them up when they hit it.
Hey,
right,
Jennifer.
Here you go. Come on, stand up.
All the guys you used
heckling all
down.
The hot ones as they walk by. You're not always going to look like that. I'm going to be there for you.
That's why I wish I was a vampire. Just so I could be alive when the bitch falls off. Blah, look at you now, huh?
A vampire. Yeah.
I would fucking sleep by day and look at bitches turn 45 by night.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
Would
you?
Would
you, Patrice?
That?
Would you?
Would you?
Come on.
That's too big.
It's a picture I tweeted yesterday. I was talking about yoga. I said, for everyone making fun of me because I do a little yoga, check this
asses.
Out. And, you know, they got caught with a bad
that's
picture of
eight asses
a
in
black
one.
Chick with about eight asses.
I'm trying to think of a
Patrice, nothing there?
No, that's some other shit.
That's some other shit going
that's
on?
Fetishy, yeah. I'll tell you another little fat pig I used to like. Remember the girl? She died, though. The girl that starred in Tom Hanks' show.
The Practice?
Holy shit, you're talking about the fucking Amy Jo Sperber?
She died?
Wendy Jo Sperber?
I had a crush on that little fat lady. She was springy.
She was the sister in Back to the Future.
I liked her.
Yeah?
That was another weird one I had a crush on. I can't say I didn't have a crush on Janet. Who's another?
Natalie.
Picked every
didn't like Natalie,
didn't like
but
Natalie.
I had a crush on Joe.
You like Joe?
I like Joe. She
you
was
like
hot.
Joe.
Yeah, I like Joe.
I like Joe.
Joe.
I like Joe. I
like
Joe.
She was like the one you could pal around with and fuck.
No, she was fucking
and I like
hot.
Her more now. When if I watched old, I go, what a dirty piece of garbage. I better.
Yes, she was.
You know, but because you get older, you know, certain things that gross you out when you was younger just don't. She just looked like she had hairy, sweaty twat.
Oh, I bet that thing was a nasty, big, killer motorcycle
down.
Chain grease in it.
Sound like Velcro, you just fucking dirty, rotten pig, you.
Look at Amy Jo Sperber.
I'm a big, I just had a crush on this Amy Jo Sperber. But from, but not, what's her name? What's the show? Bosom Buddies.
Yeah, Bosom Buddies.
I got a crush on
her
from
ironic,
Bosom
by the way.
You know? Oh, dude. I recently had
look at her. Look at this girl, man.
Look at her, she's a pig.
But it's in all due respect. I tell you who I pop to. I'll tell you who I pop right now.
Yeah.
It's very unpopular, but the pig of the year right now. It's spooky. It's Stooky.
Oh, Snooky. You would fuck
that
Snooky.
piece of little garbage, man.
You know what? That's not going out on a limb because there's a lot of guys that would fuck Snooky.
Little pig,
but she's
man.
A little fire plug pig.
Yeah,
she is.
Just a little pig. I like little pigs, man. I'm a big fan.
That's
of little
not. That's not going to end well.
No,
that's not going to end well.
That's going to be a rough one, man, for her.
Oh, she. Look at that.
Ugh, you
it's
like
just,
that? Huh?
She is just.
No, I don't.
A disaster.
I don't
like the body.
Like it. It's
like
just
what
just
she
a
represents.
Pig.
She actually looks decent there, but
just soggy tits and some weird hips that's near her knees.
Yeah, she has the shortest legs, man.
And just
she's 4'9".
Just a little pig.
Oh yeah,
4'9".
With like D level titties stuff.
She's like
a mess.
Dachshund.
Man, just a mess.
Horrible.
I like little messes. That's like a. That's just like a. I guess the drink thing.
Yeah, it's just a mess.
You just like you know just. I enjoy a little
Patrice the
shit.
Usual.
Yeah. Give me a fucking. Give me a 200 pounder with just one.
Just under 5 foot.
Big ass sloppy tits.
Let me think. Who else is a piece of a pig that's out there? Mm. It's not that many. They don't keep many pigs around.
He's like if he was a car collector, he'd like those barn finds.
Oh, those old fucking rusted buckets.
Yeah,
and
like
not
a,
even
with
fix
the,
them
with,
up
with a mouse nest in the glove compartment.
Fucking yellow jackets flying out of the air cleaner.
Everything's all original. All the numbers match. No work has been done on this since it came out of the factory.
Ah, shit. Yeah, check it. Go ahead.
Wow,
the VIN number's the same
around.
On the engine block.
Well,
look at that piece of garbage. You gotta love it.
Being arrested.
Yeah, but who's another pig?
That is
pig?
A
tremendous. Gotta be another pig.
That is a tremendous blowjob, though. I will tell you that right there.
Oh, I bet she's fucking
phenomenal.
I bet it's all spit.
Phenomenal.
She's like, when she opens her mouth, it looks like the fucking alien before it bites your heart out.
Your dick ends up smelling like the top of a bar.
It's just spit and puke.
Jesus, disgusting.
But I'm not sure that she does because pigs don't do what they used to do no more. Like. Pigs have dignity now. It's just too many.
I don't know. I think every chick is
no,
sucking
I think,
dick
I think,
now.
I think you'd be all right
it's
with
amazing.
That one. I would
it's
be.
Amazing the amount of dick-sucking girls out there now. As opposed to back when I was growing up, it was like so hard to fucking.
Really?
The hot ones are becoming very dirty now because they can't get a boyfriend.
Sucking dick. It's
walking
great.
Around lonely.
Why do you have to have an entrance? Patrice O'Neal is the only one that has to have an entrance to do a radio show.
Patrice comes in, he's pointing.
He points. And
he points.
Fucking...
He gives the old salute sometimes, a hat tip. He's flexing.
Why?
He does a little boxing move and then puts his finger out like, yeah, you, motherfucker. Patrice O'Neal.
I like being on the radio.
Yeah, it's fun.
You know I like having public opinion.
Yeah.
You know, we didn't talk about this because it happened off air, but after Patrice O'Neal's last appearance, one of the guys came marching down the hall and said, hey, you ever think about doing radio?
Oh,
after all these years of saying Patrice would be perfect for this channel, have you had discussions since then?
We did.
You did?
Yeah. He's supposed to be getting back to me this week.
Oh. Did he give him a number?
Yes.
And did you hear the gulping on the other end of the phone?
No, I really enjoy, you know, I love talking, but I really enjoy hearing guys talk that know how to stick it right in your twat. Like, just, like, nice guy. I never talked to him either. All these years, this is the first time we ever had a conversation, just on a basic level.
I actually like him.
He...
I know I beat up a lot of guys around here. I do like him.
We had a nice conversation, and you can hear... you can hear that it ain't, you know...
It's not happening.
Yeah. You can hear it. I want it to happen, but you can hear...
Well, we can all learn from Patrice. Yeah. Patrice has his... You know, he's got his number, and he's got what he will and won't do.
And well, he should.
And he will walk.
And I appreciate...
He doesn't need this that bad.
No.
So he's got, all right, if you give me this and I do this, then fine. Because they're going to try and negotiate that down.
Right. I'm not a good negotiator on any level. I just go, there's things you... the only advice I can give people out there that's get played, different things you do.
Yeah.
You can't, thank you, sir. You can't negotiate supermarket prices. Whatever. So that's one thing. You just can't talk it down.
We're not in India.
When you get in a car, if you're financing a car loan...
go with the monthly payments.
Yeah.
Just say, this is what I know I can pay monthly. Don't try to get involved with how you're getting messed around.
Uh-huh.
Don't get involved with, just say, this is what I can pay.
Right.
And when you go into, after that's the salesperson. Then when you go into the finance person, you go, I cannot go higher than this. So please don't sell me a Viper alarm. Please don't sell me a LoJack. Just,
this is it.
That's what you do. So, and when you're buying a house, it's the loan. Don't go by monthly payments. Go by the loan.
Uh-huh.
That's not going to get you in 5 years.
Uh-huh. Well, with that said, what was his reaction?
We didn't agree to disagree, though. See, I told him, I said, look, I'll give you some details, or small details.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Saturday is needed, probably. Saturday nights.
You want to do Saturday nights?
Oh, okay.
Jesus. Well, I wouldn't mind.
But that's your time to do your other thing, right?
That's the problem.
Okay.
So gotcha. So once we establish, without establishing that Saturday, I'm giving up my life.
Right. You got
so
shit
then
to
that,
do.
Then Saturday's probably out. But on the weekday is when we were talking. I come back usually Monday. I would have to adjust. So a once a week show, they need a commitment for a once a week show. And I'm cool, but I still.
How does everyone else get this one a day, two a day, three a day?
Well, they're not trying to. They're trying to ease me in. So this, you know, I'm a one a day guy to start out with. If they wanted to have me a five a day guy,
yeah,
I don't know.
You'd be a good Monday guy.
But yeah. See, Monday.
No, why? Just because a lot of shit happens on the weekends that you would be able to comment about.
That makes a lot of sense.
Sports, yeah. You know.
But then I would have to tell. I would have to tell my people to now only book me.
Yeah.
I have to come back Sunday.
Yeah. Right.
All the time.
Yep.
So I got to fix that and make sure.
There's a value there if they want you to come back a little early. I hope they can work it out. You've been on the short list for fucking... Well, you know. But I guess the audience doesn't know. Patrice has been on the short list for years.
I'm certainly interested, you know. But it was a nice... I like having corporate conversations. Because he's the man.
Yeah.
We threw in a couple of personal things. You know, he has some good personal life.
Yeah, let me tell you.
Then he took out a small one. Remember those small wooden baseball bats when you was a kid?
Yeah.
Just took you can feel a couple of ones just, you know, grab you and then you clock. You hit it. You went, ah.
It clocked you a little bit?
Yeah, just pop, pop, and you go, oh.
Probably right on the elbow or something, somewhere where it hurts.
Yeah, something you go.
A little tap to the elbow.
Yeah.
Hit that funny bone.
Yeah.
Make your arm tingle.
But it wasn't disgusting. But it's Thursday and he hasn't got back to me, so I'm thinking, I'm not thinking. I'm thinking. But I was appreciative.
My honest opinion.
I enjoyed it.
They want to get talent really, really cheap. That's their thing. That's their thing here, and it's gonna blow up in their faces eventually.
Yeah,
because people just have other options.
But in the arrogance,
because the money they would probably
Patrice.
The money I would assume they're gonna offer you, and I don't know. I don't know what's going on behind the scenes on this one. You could easily do that on your own with a podcast, easily.
Yeah, that's true.
Easily.
That's true.
And that's what these guys got to understand. We're losing guys to podcasts. That's stupid.
Less than this.
Oh, wait. Let me write it down. Less than this per week?
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. Come on now.
Wait, that's what they said?
That's... It was...
Wait, who... Was this your number?
That was...
No, this was your number, if I
remember. Whoa, wait, don't leave right now. Don't write down yet.
Oh.
It was because God bless the investigative reporting that when I used to do the Black Phillip show, that's what I got.
Wow.
But that might be an issue. Yes.
Nice.
So?
Damn.
But that was one time, or twice.
Right.
Right.
And that was by the...
But you want this.
Benevolence. For
at least
a
one day basis, yes.
I would say this.
That's what I would. But I know that that's unrealistic.
Wait, you're saying
it isn't.
You're saying this?
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I guarantee
not.
And I will bet money on this that it's more like this right now. I guarantee it. I will guarantee it.
Dude,
hit the bell. Hit the bell. Am I right?
Damn bell.
What, dude, I can't say it's a bell, but...
I'm close, though, right?
Yes, you are.
All right. I have to be.
But what you're doing is life. That's real.
That's real.
You're
not going to get you for that.
That's what was said.
What's wrong with this place?
So you're right.
Oh, my
but
God.
It was, this was what was
what
said.
What the? And when that happened last time you hear, I'm like, this is not going to... This isn't going to go well.
How do they do that with a straight face, those motherfuckers? How do they do it with a straight face?
Because you know why? Someone is saying yes every time. Who says no? People got kids.
No, people are starting to say no, and they're going elsewhere, so.
Holy shit.
But I can't be upset about it. I didn't think it was going to, because like I said, man, just give me enough to stay home for 6 months.
Right.
To make this thing an actual thing that people will go, oh, I got to depend on me.
Right.
Build it up.
This.
Right.
Like, that ends, it keeps me here.
Yeah.
And that's cheap.
Well, that is cheap.
To me.
Well, we'll work you in when Jimmy's out in L.A. Don't you worry. Nothing's going to change
you. It's like,
that's why I go home. Don't go home with hope. The sign is right on the door, sir.
No.
Don't go home with hope.
Hope is our enemy.
Hope is our enemy.
And when
I just say yeah,
Anthony
yeah,
went like this, when he poked his, when he poked his head in and said, hey, man, you're interested? Anthony went... He just put his bag on his back and just walked out the door.
Just get me the
It's mind-boggling. Say it again.
Their
strategy, I'll say it again, was to pay one guy. I have no problem with the one guy. I really don't. And everyone else has to just, like, work for pennies. And that's their philosophy. And I don't know how that works out in the long term. I just don't see how that works out. But that's their strategy. What the fuck do we know?